relatively breezy and overcast day here in Melbourne, but also quite warm as we welcome you to the MCG for this knockout semi-final. The two sides that haven't battled out in this sort of situation for almost 20 years, Richmond and Carlton. Nice to welcome one of the greats of the game, Jason Dunstall, with me once again today. Jason, as we all know, it's been a tumultuous week in world affairs. The one common thread, thankfully, is sport.
It has been a horrific week. Hopefully, events like today can go a little way towards brightening people's spirits a little bit.
I wonder how the two coaches are feeling of the respective sides at this very moment. Let's find out right now. Richard Osborne is chatting with Tigers' Danny Frawley.
Well, Dan, thanks for joining us so close to this big game. Obviously, there's a lot of rivalry between the two clubs over a long period of time. Tell us about the build-up leading up to this week and this huge clash for both clubs.
Yeah, we mentioned the clashes of the bygone days with Carlton v Richmond, and we can't do much about that. That is the tradition. We've got to make our own future, and I think for our season to be, you know, truly successful, we've achieved a lot this year, but I think, you know, getting the double chance, we realised that we need to win a final. You know, if you finish in the top four, you at least have to win a final. That's all we're aiming at this week. Last week, we were taught a good lesson about finals football against the best side in the competition, and we learned a lot from that. And it's going to be, you know, it's going to be a pretty hard-fought game out there today. And I think that our boys will have a lot more steel in their game than they did last week.
Nick Daffy and David Burke back in the side. Nick, obviously, a lot of football experience. But what are you looking for him and David today?
Yeah, Nick, he's been a little bit stiff. He's been training well the last 3 weeks. He's had a, you know, a really frustrating season with his knee. But he's fresh and he's running on top of the ground. We'll be using him through the midfield and up forward. And, you know, hopefully he can sneak a couple of goals. And I think he'll get under their guard. You know, they'd want to put a good player on him because he has trained well over the last 2 weeks. And David gives us that versatility by being a pinch hit up forward. You know, a bit of a foil for Matty and Brad Ottens up there, and as well as being able to go on one of Carlton's smaller mid-range sort of leading type players.
As a coach, Dan, you probably would have been pretty happy waking up this morning with the conditions. Ottens and Richardson, they can really cause havoc. What are you looking, again, for them today to do?
Oh, yeah, listen, they've just got to get their hands on the ball, Aussie, because, you know, and that breeds confidence. And, you know, they just didn't really get their hands on the ball too much early last week. And it's like anything, if you get a smell of the leather early, anything can happen. And, you know, they're two guys that we're going to be looking forward to for improved performance, as is, you know, the other 20 guys. We probably only had two or three winners over the whole ground last week, and you know, a lot of our wins, we've had a complete package from the 22 boys. So yeah, Matty and Brad, you know, they're going to pose a few problems, but as long as we can get some quality supply down there, as last week Essendon put us under a lot of pressure, and we've got to make sure that we do the same for Carlton.
Speaking about Carlton, you're at the game last week. You saw them have a very good game, I'd say, against Adelaide. Anthony Koutoufides is in terrific form. Obviously, he's one of the keys to their game, one you need to stop.
Yeah, no, he's a great player, and we've got a few options there with Duncan, Ben Holland, Ray Hall. But I look at our three games leading up to this. We've played North Melbourne, Essendon twice, and they've been bone-crunching affairs. And I look at Carlton's last two games against Geelong and Adelaide, and I just wonder whether they've had the better preparation. Score-wise, they have. But at the contest, I think that we've learned a lot over the last month. And we know we let ourselves down by 2 or 3% last week. And I just think we might be able to get under their guard this week.
Well, Dan, I thank you very much for joining me. You're a terrific bloke. All the best today, and all goes well for Richmond Football Club.
Yeah, no, we've been one hell of a shake, Oz.
Well done, mate. Thanks.
Interesting, Jason. A lot of people have been riding the Tigers off all week, but Danny, to his credit, has been pumping up their tyres.
He has. Look, he's got one final under his belt. It wasn't a great one, but if they want that respect that he's so desperately searching for, they need to win today.
Well, his opponent today is Wayne Brittain, the Carlton coach. Here he is with another former Blue, Ian Robertson.
Well, Wayne, I know it's a, you know, it's a very important time of the day for you in particular. You've got one dead set pressure game under your belt against the Crows, who beat you twice during the season. You come up against the Tigers. They are a traditional opponent of Carlton. What's the focus been during the week? I mean, you've got players that have played a minimal number of finals, and you've also had this diversion, I suppose, of the events overseas.
Yeah, everyone's had that diversion, so we're not on our own with that. And we've got plenty of players in our team that's got plenty of finals experience as well. So, I mean, our focus this week, Richmond beat us in round 11 this year. So, I mean, they played some pretty good footy that day. It was Silvani's 300. You know, like, but our form going into this game, and like last week was good, the week before that, our last month has been really good. We're playing our best footy at the right time, and that's all I can ask for with our group. You know, they'll go out there, they'll have a massive crack, and we're in good form. So Richmond will have to do something special to beat us.
Do you hone in on a special group of players? I mean, the public out there know about Richardson, know about Ottens, know about Campbell. Are there any other players that would specifically be targeted as far as your strategy is concerned in the Richmond lineup?
I mean, look, you target all of them. I mean, the defence is very underrated. They do a good job. Gasper's one of the best centre-half-backs in the competition. I mean, he's the All-Australian centre-half-back. So, you know, and then you've got Chaffee and Cameron, who have been pretty damaging across half-back as well. I mean, you have to look at their whole team in its entirety, you know, not just one or two players. I mean, they've obviously got their gun players the same as we have, but you really got to look at them right across the board, because if we win today, it'll be because we've got contributions from everyone, not just brilliant contributions from one or two, but contributions from everyone.
Are there any players that can lift from last week? I mean, it was a pretty good performance last week. Are there any individuals in your lineup that could lift?
I mean, there's plenty of individuals, but the focus is the team at this time of year. It's not the individuals, you know. So the expectations on each bloke is exactly the same, you know. If we're going to lift, it'll be because it's right across the board. Everyone's done a little bit more.
What was the thinking behind Porter being left out for Franchina? It's a big risk, isn't it, Franchina, with a hamstring injury?
Yeah, I mean, you take those type of risks at this time of year. Let's just wait and see who's out there.
Yeah, well, okay. Well, as I said earlier, Wayne, it's a very, very important game. I mean, you play for big stakes these days, and it's a pretty good day for footy, nice and cool. So may the Blues do the job for you.
Yeah, let's hope so. I mean, like I said before, we're in good form, so Richmond will have to play pretty well to beat us.
Good on you, Wayne. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Robert.
The AFL, in association with its premier partner, Carlton and United, proudly presents the 2001 Premiership season.
Well, we're going to have a big crowd here today as they start to pour in. I wonder, did Wayne Brittain give anything away there, Jason?
Well, he hinted that there may be a selection change. We'll have to wait and see when they run out exactly what happens there. But people from all walks of life here, Sandy, children and adults, all in the mix there, hoping to enjoy a great day.
And a big day for a couple of players. Scott Camporelli playing his 150th. Yep. Huge day for Craig Bradley, as equals the Flying Doormats games record of 356. And also, for those who are trivia buffs when it comes to dates, you might remember September 15, 2000, on this very day in Sydney last year. Here was the man, Jason, who led the Australian Olympic team out onto the Sydney ground for the start of the Olympic Games opening ceremony. And a reminder for all viewers, you can see a replay of that opening ceremony tonight on 7 after tonight's clash from Football Park. But wherever you may be viewing, just check your local guides for that. We'll reminisce over the Olympics while we take a break and then be back to check out these two sides with Paul Salmon.
Today will be the 22nd finals clash between these arch rivals. The last time they met in a first semi-final was back in 75. On that occasion, almost 77,000 fans braved the treacherous conditions and saw the inaccurate Tigers win by 9 points and advance to the preliminary final. Their last meeting in a semi-final of any kind was the second semi-final of 82. The top of the ladder Tigers jumped the Blues early. The finals experience of David Cloak and Kevin Bartlett helped the Tigers to a 30-point lead at quarter time, and that sent Hungary into raptures. On the other hand, the normally unflappable Flying Doormat was signifying the Blues woes. Richmond running out 23-point winners and booking their spot in the 1982 Grand Final. The Blues eventually joined the Tigers on that last day in September, but this time it was Carlton out of the blocks early, led by the inspirational Wayne Harms. The whopping crowd of over 107,000 was treated to a typically fiery affair. The Blues withstanding all the Tigers could dish out at them and then responding in the best possible way. And when the buzz marked and found teammate Kenny Hunter in traffic, the Blues' 14th flag was theirs for the keeping.
It could be a goal coming up. Yes, it's a goal.
Remarkably, Carlton have won only 5 of their 21 finals against Richmond. Can they add to that today? Find out after the break.
Remember round 11, it was a sad day for Stephen Silvani. He played his 300th game, but the Blues copped a 27-point hiding at the hands of the Tigers, and the Richmond Football Club will be looking to emulate that feat today. Also join us, I'm happy to say, there's another one of the greats of the game in days gone by in Paul Salmon. Paul, we're talking about major milestones. They don't come much bigger than Craig Bradley as he joins the Flying Doormat on 356.
He's been a fantastic player, hasn't he? Just not for Carlton, but for the whole league in general. He's been a wonderful player and midfielder for such a long time. 356 games, Jason, matching the great Bruce Doole. That's a wonderful effort in anyone's language.
Oh, it is. I had the privilege of playing on Bruce Doole in his last game in the 86 Grand Final. He was a hero of mine, and it's only fitting that someone of the quality of Craig Bradley should be the man that equals his record today.
And if people are wondering how many you kicked on him that day, I think it was six. Let's have a look at him in action. Now, this was last week, and it just shows what a running machine he was.
Well, it's a great example, Sandy. You're dead right. This is the defensive 50, midway through the last quarter in last week's final against Adelaide. There's Bradley just trotting through as Prendergast has the ball. Of course, Bradley just chipped it over to him. Christou takes a mark on the outer wing. Let's have a look as the look in the foreground, the highlighted player. That's Craig Bradley. He's got 10 yards on his opponent already. Christou, he knows the long kick of the football will go long to Whitnall. He's just bolted, and he finds himself at the back of the pack at this contest. There he is again. He's a wonderful player, running machine. This guy's nearly 38, we shouldn't forget. And a wonderful captain. Here he is, the old 1-2 from Lappin, and Lappin goal.
And here he is now leading out this Carlton outfit. 356 games, he turns 38 in a little over 3 weeks' time. After joining this club from crossing the border in South Australia in 1986 with several other players, he has been an ornament not only to the game but especially to the Carlton Football Club, and he joins Bruce Doole on 356. A mighty, mighty achievement. And there's Scott Camporelli next to him with his mop of black hair. He plays his 150th game today, and we certainly wish him well in that. We're talking about Carlton last week, and you were with the aid of your telestrator, Paul, able to pick up the way they used the kick-in last week with Kuda.
Well, this was a very interesting set play from the Blues, and Kuda was isolated out the back of the big huddle inside 50. There he is. We've arrowed him there. Look, he was just wonderful last week. This guy, when he's on song, is an awesome sight. We look at the set play there, all the Blues huddle in the middle. Adelaide were going man on man, as they often do this year. There's Kuda at the back, one-on-one with Bickley yet again. That big cluster of players is going to get front and square. They didn't need to on a lot of occasions because Koutoufides was just awesome in the air. And there they are again. They are just bolting to the front of the contest. But as we see, once again, Kuda in front of Bickley, and the long kick, he cleaned up Jason. He's been fantastic over the last month.
Yeah, it wasn't just last week he was great. The last month he's taken his game to another level. And I think it's fair to say he's probably the key to Carlton's chances throughout the final series. If he can maintain these sort of performances, it's virtually unbeatable one-on-one, especially given the height advantage in a midfield role. He can do some serious damage.
It's interesting to look at players as we see Porter. Mark Porter is out on the ground. So Wayne Brittain did give something away in that interview with Ian Robertson. Franchina is out, very suspect with that hamstring, and Porter with his height coming back into the side. Interesting to look at players when they change clubs, and Carlton have picked up a couple of absolute beauties. Jimmy Plunkett and Matty Lappin, who booted five last week.
Well, Lappin's five goals last week was a real key difference in the two teams. Here he is at the back of a boundary, throwing in the forward pocket. We know he likes to push off his opponent. That's the arrows, his running pattern. All the space in the front of the contest, Carlton have left it open for him. Not many players find passages through to goal like this little fella, Matty Lappin. Quite dangerous in that situation. So the Tigers have to be on their toes. He's also prepared to work up the field at centre wing there. He kicked it in forward, a big contest. He seems to be able to find space. And certainly, on a lot of occasions, he doesn't have an opponent. So I don't think he'll get this much space today. But we see him pushing into this big hole. He took that mark and kicked the goal, converted. A really dangerous individual, Jason. But they've been spreading the load.
Oh, they have. Look, he's a terrific, dedicated small forward, Lappin, that gets amongst the goals. But there's eight of them that have kicked more than 20. And that is a great spread of the workload up forward, which just means it's going to be a lot more difficult for Richmond today to try and shut down the capacity to put the score on the board. And when you look, flip the coin, have a look at Richmond's five goal kickers, I guess, that have really got amongst it, still a heavy reliance on the two big key marking forwards.
Well, the Tigers just about set to make their way out. Here is Wayne Campbell, the boy from Golden Square in the Bendigo League. It's a hugely popular league. He leads them out. They get a second chance and they need it. There's Jason Tawney, Chaffee, Ottens and co, the Kellaway boys, and Rogers and Broderick now in the veteran pass. Guys like Broderick and Benny Gale ought to be absolutely lapping this up, realising that maybe this is their last chance, Jason.
Well, there's a lot of players that haven't had the opportunity before, and you can play for a long time and not get this sort of opportunity. They lost last week, they need to bounce back this week, and they realise that this may be the only time they're involved in the final series.
Let's have a look at their opponents today. We'll have a look at the Carlton lineup. As we have said, Porter is back in. Franchina is out of the lineup, so Porter in, no change for Carlton.
Yes, Greg, Glenn Mann, he'll get one of the big guns for the Tigers, so he's got a big job down back for Carlton.
The half-back line, Jason, is a very strong unit too, and Andrew McKay continues to rebound strongly, a dangerous attacking defender for the Blues.
Yeah, he has been great. Sylvani, of course, expect him to line up on Richardson. but it's pretty well balanced. Simon Beaumont, now he's a player that's played in a lot of positions down back. He spent time on ball, on a wing, very damaging, great pace. The old man himself, father time, Craig Bradley in the middle, he'll be getting amongst it today as well.
Look, the half forward line there, Matty Lappin, he's dangerous. Lance Whitnall, that match up with Gasper could be great.
Koutoufides at full forward, I doubt that. Expect him to spend most of his time on ball, and he's going to be another damaging contributor.
And the ruck division's very good. As we said, Jimmy Plunkett has really stood up. He'll get closer attention today.
And I tell you what, you've got to like the balance on the bench. They've got the big bloke, the backup for Matthew Allen. They've got a forward in for Bowler and a couple of utilities in Fletcher and Freeborn. So good balance. A good spread of talent right across the ground for Carlton.
The old yellow and black song is going on behind us in the background, but if there was one area, Paul, of Richmond that must lift after last week, probably their midfield.
It certainly is. They really need to get a lot more of the ball. Look at the accountability in some of these set plays last week. Up to 8 players, all arm across the body, and they made it the real contest against the Bombers, but the Bombers, as we know, are so good in that department. At times, Matty Knights, he'll want to find more space today. Will he go to a player like Plunkett? Only time will tell, but he was wrapped up by McVeigh on a number of occasions, didn't get any breathing space at all. On the rare occasion the Tigers did find space, and there was some laziness by the Bombers, rare occasion, they did make most of the opportunities. Tivendale on the back door, they're playing a little bit of peekaboo. Carousella can't find his opponent. The ball does pop out this occasion. A great finish by Tivendale. They'll need all things working for them today.
Yeah, it probably goes further than just accountability. They really have to get amongst the possessions today, Richmond's midfield. Look at what they're up against. Koutoufides, Plunkett, Bradley. Camporelli, don't expect him to be that quiet 2 weeks in a row. So honestly, if they're going to be a chance to Tigers, they've got to get plenty of possession in the midfield to give their forwards a chance.
And two of those forwards are this man wearing number 12 in Matty Richardson and Mr. Ottens as well. Brad Ottens has been a sensation this year.
The top two in terms of rankings in the competition for marks, and also 100 goals between them. So obviously a big percentage of the responsibility will fall on their shoulders today. And as we said, if they can get enough ball forward and give them one-on-one opportunities, they could get the Tigers over the line.
Well, Jason, they've opted for experience in this knockout final. Goodbye to Fiora and Zantuck, and welcome back the experience of Nick Daffy and David Burke.
Certainly. And look down back, Leon Cameron, he's been brilliant for them. Really sets play up, gives them a lot of drive out of defence.
Darren Gasper's competition or contest against Whitnall could be pivotal in this game today, I'm sure.
Yeah, and we mentioned how big a task it's going to be for the midfield. Matthew Knights, he needs to have a big one today and pump the ball forward regularly.
Well, they're the two monoliths at the half forward line, Richardson and Ottens. They're power forwards and they'll cause a lot of problems.
Ben Holland's an interesting one, could be used in a lot of different roles, could be down back, could be up forward. Danny Frawley even mentioned perhaps on Koutoufides.
A lot of time for Benny Gale on the ruck, Jason. He's been a wonderful performer and a real workhorse.
And Daffy, of course, he'll be itching to get out on the ground. Expect to see him getting plenty of game time, I think. They'll really expect the occasion to fire him up. It's a pretty good-looking lineup. I mean, it really doesn't pale in significance when you compare it to Carlton's lineup. So they'll be keen.
Well, there are the combatants for this knockout final. Does this man hold the key? He's been sensational over the past 4 weeks. Stay with us here at the MCG. It's coming your way right after this break.
Well, this is one of the great sights in modern sport. A packed MCG, wonderful atmosphere, and two sides contesting a grand final. One of our commentators who's tasted success in three grand finals with Carlton, 68, 70 and 72, is Ian Robertson, and he's with us today. Welcome, Robbo.
That is a terrific sight, isn't it, Sandy? And if you want to get any idea of where the support of AFL football has dominated, it's here in Victoria, and you get two traditional rivals. The supporters of both teams do come out in their numbers, especially when they're playing each other in a final.
Time now for official proceedings to begin, and here's our master of ceremonies down at ground level, Craig Willis.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Australian Football League and its premier partner Carlton and United welcome you to the first semi-final. Would you now join with the players and the umpires in a minute's silence as a mark of respect for the tragedy which has occurred in the United States of America.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Please remain standing now for the National Anthem of Australia.
For the next 2.5 hours, the problems of the world will be pushed aside as one of these teams looks to take another major step towards another grand final clash. Here are the skippers coming down for the toss of the coin, the running machine on the left in Craig Bradley, and Wayne Campbell. What a thrill for him to skipper this side who's made such a resurgence. He wins the toss and kicks to the right of screen. A blustery day, Jason, that may make it fairly tough for some of the big boys.
Yeah, it certainly could. It is blowing quite fiercely here at the moment. We hope that doesn't have an adverse effect on conditions. Would really like to see these two teams matching skills in perfect conditions. And in particular, the big forwards. If the ball starts to float around a bit, it could certainly reduce their effectiveness on a day like this.
What about matchups, key matchups in particular? We're looking at Anthony Koutoufides. Duncan Kellaway, the man.
Well, you'd think he'd probably get the starting job. Danny Frawley mentioned Ben Holland, also Ray Hall as options. Expect Kellaway to get it. And it's not a matter of stopping Kurt. I don't think you can stop him full stop. What you have to do is try and moderate his influence. He's giving away a fair height advantage, I guess, in terms of stature. Just need to keep him out of the attacking 20. Lance Whitnall's another. Expect him to play a key role today. He is one of the best at actually leading his opponent to a contest and then losing him in traffic. And then all of a sudden he bobs up forward, kicking goals. Darren Gasper's the man that'll pick him up. He gets all the guns, rarely lowers his colours, although he's had a pretty tough night, tough fortnight against Matthew Lloyd, so he'll be ready to bounce back with a big one today.
Let's go ground level once again in our boundary rider for the day. He'd be loving this atmosphere. He's played in atmospheres like this. Richard Osborne, welcome, Aussie.
Yes, thanks, Sandy. As you said, it's an amazing atmosphere down here, 80-plus thousand people. Apart from that swirly wind, terrific conditions for football. So I'm just interested to see Anthony Koutoufides, a superstar last week. He's going to have a big impact on this game today, boys. It's going to be a big one.
Straight to Bradley. Allen on the ball for Carlton. But remember, Porter's in, Francina's out. Campbell and Koutoufides.
Gasper's gone back onto Favola.
Holland on his own in the defensive 50. Whitnall on the wing.
Allen wins it. Kellaway leads in the race. Plenty of pushing and shoving. An excellent tackle on Duncan Kellaway. His brother is there as well. And there's Adrian Hickmott. Real Terrier is the Carlton number 9, playing his 152nd game. Smashed back in towards the middle. Jimmy Plunkett, sensational game last week. Up towards Houlihan and Whitnall. Neither were able to take the mark. Hume down on all fours. They crash in on him, and there will be a bounce.
Duncan Kellaway, the antagonist there, just making it difficult for Darren Hume. And I think he may have just snuck up on Darren Hume there. It'll be interesting to see how he recovers. He's the last, really, to regain his footing. And the Carlton players didn't like the way Duncan Kellaway jumped in there.
It's on 50. He gets another crack at it. Down towards full forward. One, two grabs. Not paid. Now it's Camporelli and Co. who pounce on it.
I think it's good, Jason, that the umpires do jump on that. The guys that are coming in a split second too late can do damage to the player who's at least made the play with the football.
You're right, Robert. They're trying to certainly make them earn it the hard way. That was nearly a spectacular mark by Favola. But the umpire's keen to bounce the ball quickly and move it on.
Well, that was a poor kick. And now Adrian Hickmott will send Carlton back into attack. Oh, he could go short if he likes, and he does, to Houlihan, who's inside 50. Another one into the pocket. And this Richmond defence is being tested very early on.
Gee, it was unusual, first of all, for Ryan Houlihan to be left on his own.
But Lappin.
Well, Lappin did provide a lead, at least. The player was there trying to watch Lappin.
It's a bit on behind play. It's on behind play. Koutoufides.
Gale.
And Brendan Gale.
Allen is there as well. In the meantime, Lappin, who booted five last week, is just confirming exactly where the mark is.
Koutoufides telling the emergency umpire too what he thought about that.
He was smart, Brendan Gale. He got right in the thick of it until the emergency umpire came out and said stop it, then threw his hands up.
And Camporelli is coming off with the blood rule, so something connected. Now, let's get back to Lappin.
It's Scott Freeborn who's taken his place too, Sandy.
Duncan Kellaway may not have started on Koutoufides at the centre bounce, but he's certainly picking him up now in general play.
Lappin for the first score of the day. 35 metres out. Fairly tight angle. Fairly tight angle.
Ooh.
One behind.
Must have gone very close. The crowd behind thought it had snuck through. Certainly Lappin was pretty confident with the kick. And it just takes a good kick early just to settle the team's nerves down.
So Leon Cameron with the football for Richmond. They've been under a little bit of a siege in the opening minutes of the game. The short kick is for Campbell. Campbell is at right half back. Handball over the top. Kellaway looks down the ground and delivers long and high. Goes past the wing. Plunkett, assisted by Koutoufides, already into the play. Goes across the half back line. And the mark will be taken by Allen. He could find Lappin further down the ground. And it bounces awkwardly for Lappin. Very, very awkwardly. It's a contest on centre wing between Lappin and Tawney, and it will be a ball up. Silvani and Holland, along about 85, 100 metres. The emergency umpire speaking to both of those players. Our umpires for the game are Brian Sheehan, Brett Allen, and Mark McKenzie. So some good experience blended with, you know, the youth of McKenzie and Allen. Brian Sheehan, of course, has been around for quite a while.
Camporelli set to come back on, left the ground just for a moment with a blood rule. Hickmott again in the thick of things. The Kellaway hand pass just a little too short. McKay, the door opens for the veteran.
He ran a long way.
He did run a long way, but he finds Houlihan in the middle of the ground. He wants to go on with it, and he does. Here's a chance now for Fletcher to look into the forward line for Carlton. The Tigers have the numbers. The mark not held. Porter loses it to Knights. Knights over the top once again. Gasper in trouble. Favola gets him. The ball spilled free. Porter pounces on it. Well done by the big man. Gets it out quickly towards Fletcher. He comes back inboard to Bradley. Bradley goes for home. In towards the square he goes. Whitnall was his target. Hickmont is there as well. He finds the boundary line, but he keeps it in play. Bends it back with a check side. All to no avail, and Camporelli comes back out onto the ground.
Gee, there was some magnificent desperation from Mark Porter at ground level. He just threw the big body on the ball. He stopped it coming out. They had the numbers. Look at that. That's just being more desperate. Feeding it out to Favola.
No doubt about Mark Porter's endeavours there. Short kick is to Cameron. Cameron, they still to clear their defensive 50. Gasper, good long kick in the direction of and finds Richardson.
That's a 70-metre lead, Robbo. A 70-metre lead.
Great take too, Jason, wasn't it?
Yep.
A confidence start there by Matthew Richardson. Now Leon Cameron into full forward. The mark is taken by Ottens. We all know the abilities of Matthew Richardson and Brad Ottens, and already they have had a key part in this build-up opportunity for Richmond's first goal.
Well, he's one of the guns, one of the trump cards, Brad Ottens. I'll tell you, it was an extremely intelligent kick from Leon Cameron. He hadn't actually led, and when Cameron got it, he saw that he was in front position, so he just chipped it short and made him actually run there, and he was just quick enough off the mark to leave Glenn Manton a couple of yards behind.
A couple of chances to the Blues have resulted in behinds. Ottens going for Richmond's first. Good kick. It just floats away. I think he's just missed, has he?
It certainly started on track, and we did mention pretty blustery conditions. It's not just marking that'll play havoc with. Certainly kicking becomes a very important part of it. And he can handle the conditions the best.
Yeah, as you said, Jace, it is a little blowy down here. That would have been just what the doctor ordered for the Tigers to kick that goal. It's been very physical early. The test is on for the Tigers at this stage.
It's going to be interesting to see how Silvani goes with Richardson. He loves a long lead, quite often 100 yards or so, 100 metres.
I tell you what, they tried to kick it to Koutoufides from the kick out like last week, but the Tigers were onto it.
Bradley's got the free kick from half back. Penetrating towards the half forward line. The diving attempt by Hall, not good enough. Maybe a chance now for Lappin. Can't pick it up. blanket court. Extremely well tackled by Kellaway. Free kick, Sandy, and it will come back.
I think the umpire had a bit of a look and saw that maybe it was not to Richmond's advantage, so he's going to bring it back.
Andrew Kellaway has not missed a game this year. He's been very good as he goes into the middle and finds Rogers. Matty Rogers, 159 games, long into half forward once again. No one able to take it cleanly. Maybe a chance for the Blues to defend wide towards the defensive 50. Hulme comes in over the top. On all fours, they scramble it towards the boundary line. Was it deliberate? Throw it in.
Good contest a moment ago between Silvani and Richardson. Silvani really wrapped the arm around him, and you can expect him to test the umpire's patience a couple of times. Knights and Bradley, just one of the matchups we'll see today, is some great ones.
Allen doing the work from behind. Pushes wide, Hickmont. Around the body he goes, flicking it back towards centre wing. Mark is going to be paid, is it?
No.
No, it is not. De Porter, it slipped through. Plunkett is there as well, and there'll be another bounce.
Sandy, I read in the paper that Darren Hulme was given some plaudits for his job on Andrew McLeod last week. He's been asked to repeat the dose on Wayne Campbell today by the look of what's happened so far.
Big test for him. It's just in Richmond's attacking zone. Still looking for our first goal. Gale pushing it wide. Kellaway, Koutoufides on his hammer, but he manages to get it away. Flicked in towards the half-forward line. Hilton's at the back. Can he get a run at it? Hilton towards the pocket. Beaumont pushes to the line. Hilton won't get a chance. And we've got a throw in.
Oh.
Well, we have a free kick. Hilton is ironed and condom. And he's got a free kick. What did you think, Jason?
Well, look, there's always going to be a bit of play acting. There is absolutely nothing in that. It's a ridiculous free kick, but the key to it is there was no need to be involved in it at all from Simon Beaumont. He would have been better off just walking the other way.
Particularly, Jace, that close to goal, as you said, there may not have been a lot in it. You just can't run that risk. It's almost a certain goal now.
In actual fact, the kick should have gone the other way for pushing the head down.
Hilton.
He's missed it.
He's missed. He has missed from...
done it again! Went straight up and bucked him to the ground again.
There's a fine line between being aggressive and standing up for yourself and not being stupid, Robbo, and I think he's treading it. He's tiptoeing on that line right now. He wanted to give him a spray after he missed it, and again, there wasn't a lot in it, but just be careful.
Unnecessary, ridiculous rot.
In the meantime, play goes on as Matten from the back pocket. Kicks towards centre wing. Ottens will drop back, but Allen is there. Lappin, it ricochets away from him. He gets another chance, but he runs into his own teammate in Mansfield, and we've got a throw in.
Not so bad, because they're both pretty desperate to get hold of the footy. A little bit of misunderstanding. Right on centre wing in front of the players' interchange area here at the cricket ground. Koutoufides to take it away. Missed his target with a handball. Allen and Sziller. Sziller's able to gather. Did he step over the line? He may have just. The kick was marked by Matthew Lappin anyway, but the boundary umpire will throw it in. A little closer to the Carlton goal, just forward of centre wing. Richmond have scrambled three behinds. The Blues have scrambled a couple. Allen and Brendan Gale. Allen from the back gets the tap down. Koutoufides, head pass was meant for Lappin, just maybe a little too emphatic. Equally as so on Broderick. He was able to shrug the tackle. Campbell in towards half court. The mark was taken by Richardson.
There's got players on in the middle.
Good signs for Richmond if Richardson can get his hands on the ball early like he has. McKay's got to turn around. The bounce was awkward. Got the handball away. Beaumont. Left foot kick by Beaumont across the line out in front of Fletcher. Look at that awkward bounce. Chaffee gathered. Missed his target with the handball, which was intended for Andrew Kellaway. The tackle by Hickmott was ineffective. Andrew Kellaway's kick into the pocket is all right. And the mark was taken by Joel Bowden.
Bowden
is in the wrong pocket, really, for a left footer.
Well, he is. They had a couple of options there. He definitely wanted the ball. He is a very good kick of the footy. You wouldn't say it's an impossible kick by any stretch of the imagination, Andrew Kellaway. You see him turn around here. There's actually two players there. And Matthew Rogers would have been quite happy to take it, I think. But in the end, the front man, Joel Bowden, just needs to steady his side with a straight kick here.
He's gone back 30 metres from the man on the mark. Man on the mark is about 35 metres from goal, and Bowden will kick from just inside 50 and may have missed everything. So I think early watching, you can get an idea that these conditions are a little awkward. The sky a little overcast, no real threat of rain, but a blustery wind blowing, and it's making it extremely difficult for the players to contend with.
Bowden had 30 possessions last week. He's in form. So are the big men of the Tigers early on. This is Richardson passing Rogers. He may get another chance. McKay's right on his hammer. Rogers tries to push it forward, but taken by Manton, who gives it to Hulme. The advantage is going to be paid. No real advantage.
Pretty obvious, isn't it, that these absolute class players on the ground are going to be targeted physically if they're given the opportunity.
It's a solid bump, isn't it?
Camborelli. His 150th game today. Been a magnificent player since coming over from Woodville West Torrens. Drifted into the middle and finds Hulme. Goes back to Camborelli. Chance to bounce his way between halfback and centre. Towards the right half forward. It's a poor kick. It puts a bit of pressure on Allen. Gets a call out the back, and they're going to need it too. Picked up by Beaumont. It'll go onto that left foot and just chip it in towards half forward. That's not a good kick. And once again, doing the tidying up is Joel Bowden. Hasn't missed a game this year. They set off through Mark Chappie, taking the hand pass from Hilton up towards the half forward line. Bradley went a little early. Cam was there. Bradley tries to steal it. Knights comes in with Hulme, pushes towards the line. Hulme continues to pressure. They squat on it, and it is on the line. Three behinds to Richmond, two behinds to Carlton, but the Tigers have made a far better start this week.
As you'd expect, plenty of pressure early. Pretty fierce approach on the ball from both sides, and a couple of players just fumbling a little bit, dropping the odd mark.
Gale tries to take it out of the air. Jimmy Plunkett tries to take it away from him, but Duncan Kellaway's got other ideas.
See, that was interesting. I think both Brendan Gale and Matthew Allen thought that there was a boundary throw-in going to happen over there. And the umpire decided on a bounce. They quickly had to run about 30 metres.
This time they've got the throw in. Gale just tries to almost palm it down to Broderick. He did well off to Knights. Danger time again for the Blues. Knights in towards full forward. Richardson wants the free kick. And he's got it! Richard! 20 metres out, almost directly in front.
There's been a bit going on between the two of them, and it looks like a blood rule against Silvani as well. He's being told to go off with the blood rule. Still wants to argue the decision about the free kick. There's been plenty on the couple of contests they've had. It's pretty clear that Matthew Richardson's going to try and run Silvani around. He's certainly been heavily involved early on. A couple of great marks to Richardson. And you can just see this one. Silvani, he's got his back to the ball. He nearly hits him in the back, in actual fact. And the one thing you have to do as a defender in that instance, and Soss will know that, at some stage you've got to turn and make sure you give at least the impression to the umpire that you're tracking the ball. Bit of holding on going from both of them, but probably unfairly taking Richardson out of the contest.
56 goals, 34 behinds.
An important kick for Richo, this one.
This for the first goal of the day. Richardson kicks the goal. The Tigers are away.
They're very pleasing signs for Richmond fans, and they are out in force here at the MCG. The most important thing is to see that man there in action early. Four possessions, a couple of marks. This time the recipient of a free kick, Silvani, just not interested in the ball. Obviously very concerned about the influence that Richardson can play today. And most importantly for Matthew Richardson, a good kick to start proceedings. That'll do his confidence the world of good.
So the free kick to Matthew Richardson, resulting in a goal. Stephen Silvani has got rid of the long sleeve Guernsey. And away go the Tigers once again from the centre bounce. He's got it again. Gee, the signs are ominous, aren't they? Because Carlton perhaps very much Ottens conscious. And along slips Matthew Richardson in his third mark, plus a free kick. He may get his second goal.
The other thing here is all of a sudden he's been freed up from the Silvani matchup with the blood rule. He gets Trent Houghton, who comes out pretty cold, trying to get there. Unfortunately, a little bit obstructed by his teammate and skipper, Craig Bradley, in trying to come over the top. But wouldn't this be a fantastic start for the Tigers if Matthew Richardson can kick straight again?
One goal, three to two behinds. Richardson for his second. It's a pretty good kick. He's kicked it, I think. Just. No. Missed.
Well, I'll tell you what, he is still furious. He was celebrating. He had the arms up.
He thought he'd kicked it. It's one of those that's obviously gone very close to the left-hand goalpost. But he raised both arms in triumph. If you can just see him at the top of the screen, look at the kick coming through.
And you would have done that a few times when you were playing, wouldn't you?
He thought it was the goal. He's clapping.
Talk the goal umpire into something.
Yeah, I'll try and bluff him if you can.
The advantage won't be paid. Beaumont's going to have to bring the ball back. Broderick. Joel Bowden from 50. It's bending back, but not nearly enough.
I'll tell you what's an amazing statistic. They had it inside their attacking 50 the first three times of the game, Carlton. But since then, the last eight have been all Richmond.
And boys, just keep your eyes on Steve Silvani. After giving that free kick away to Paul Broderick, he's come up limping. So a little bit sore, I'd say.
That ball hitting the behind post. So the Tigers get another chance, and it's Kellaway looking to go short to Leon Cameron, one of the best deliverers of the ball in the business. Cameron into half forward, into the danger zone. Bowden! Joel Bowden is suddenly giving them something to think about.
Oh, it was a terrific kick by Leon Cameron.
He's a great deliverer.
And I'll tell you what, after he took the mark, Robbo, there was a rather anxious look from Simon Beaumont, who's involved in the contest. He was expecting the ruckman, Matthew Allen, to come over the top and punch it, but he was looking for the chest mark over the back. Really should have gone with a big fist, Matthew Allen, over the top and hit the ball towards the boundary line.
Bowden then for his first goal. 25 for the year, 25-22. 42 metres out. He's kicked the goal for the Tigers. What a start they've made here at MCG.
They have. It's been a very important start for the Tigers. I think a lot of people are of the opinion that Carlton would win and win comfortably today. Danny Frawley's been crying out for respect all year. And you see the way the ball gets squared into Leon Cameron and then he finds Joel Bowden. But it's important that the Tigers have a great start, because I think if it had been the other way around, it would have been very easy for Carlton to run away with the match.
Lee Matthews and some of his Lions staff having a close look at this game.
I think your mate Craig Lambert's up there with him, Sandy.
Yep, they've seen Richmond score the last two goals for after the Blues did the early attacking. It's all of a sudden been one-way traffic. Now Gale's got a free kick out of the middle.
Yes, the Blues had plenty of chances in the early 3 or 4 minutes, but it's been all Richmond since then. 2-4 to two behinds, and Richmond have received 6 free kicks to 4 now. Is that unusual? 10 free kicks already. We've still got something like about 10 minutes left in the term.
And a big discrepancy in the inside 50 as well. They had the first three, Carl. The last 10 have been all Richmond.
Now, well, that gives you an idea, doesn't it? A few ironical cheers coming from the fans because a free kick has been found in favour of the Blues to be taken by their ruckman, Matthew Allen. He goes across the full back line. Silvani, players peeling off him, quite prepared to allow him to bounce the ball nearly to outside 50.
Ooh,
then goes very
play.
Wide. And right on the boundary line, Matthew Rogers can't control it. And we'll get a report of the behind-the-play incident from Jason Dunstall.
Plenty going on between Stephen Sziller and Scott Camporelli. They both went to ground, and I don't think that's the first time we'll see that happen. Roderick and Plunkett, one of the other on-ball matchups, but Sziller and Camporelli is wearing him like a glove.
As Stephen Sziller does. Mansfield just tried a little poke down in front. Didn't really work, and there'll be a bounce on 50 for Richmond. They lead 2-4 to the Blues, two behinds. The goal's coming from Joel Bowden and Matthew Richardson.
Got a little beauty down here in front of us, Sandy. Just sorry for interrupting. Hume chasing Knights, chasing Bradley. A little little dancing act down here in front of us at centre half forward for Richmond.
They're still outside 50.
Another free kick to the Tigers.
Well, they're getting the opportunities.
You wonder whether, you know, I mean, they're in first, aren't they?
Here's Campbell. Campbell into half forward. Three of them flew. Manton's at the back. Steadies it down, comes towards Hume on the half-back flank, and he'll look towards the centre wing. Porter lopes to that position, McKay's short, that's where he heads. Andy McKay's got a little bit of room. He steadies at centre wing, goes wide, too wide for Houlihan, and it's just taken over the line for a throw-in. Just in Carlton's attacking zone, that's Mark Chaffee with the ball, got the job on Houlihan.
Gee, there is plenty of spirit out there. As soon as a couple of players' paths cross, no one's taking a backward step.
Plunkett and Broderick lapping through, but without it. Porter going to get a free kick.
Gee, umpire Mark McKenzie was right on the scene. That's been plucked from Brian Sheehan.
Yeah, that was off
ball. It was 40 metres away.
Yeah. It was an off-ball decision, that one against Tawney.
Lappin into the pocket. Throw in. Beaumont unable to take the mark. Gasper defending pretty well.
Well, Wayne Brittain, in the interview that I did with him before the match, mentioned that they had a lot of respect for Richmond's defence.
Yep.
And a few eyebrows were raised in the commentary box when I mentioned that, Sandy. And they are doing a pretty good job. The Blues still searching for their first goal.
Gale and Porter. Gale tries to pluck it out of the air. Can't get clear, however. Now they've got an opportunity. Oh. Hilda just went short, but it's going to be effective. Holland chipping to centre wing. It's a poor kick.
Gee, and disgust on the face of Matthew Richardson, yeah, because he had led Silvani up and had 5 metres break. All he needed was a good kick.
He was going to eat it, wasn't he? Not to be. Now Whitnall pumping it. Wobbly, although it is. The mark has been taken.
No, not paid.
Not be paid. Lapping over the line.
He looked like he had a good grip on it, Anthony Koutoufides, but it must have got knocked out in the contest. We'll have a good look at it here. He gets front position against Duncan. Kellaway grabs it there, but it spills out pretty quickly. Perhaps didn't control it. Good decision. There's a great view of it. Did not control the ball.
5 minutes remaining in the quarter. Lappin tried to find Houlihan. He was unsuccessful. Oh, look at the tackle of Camporelli. Locked up. Hall in trouble. Tries to shrug Houlihan, but then Lappin comes again, and Hilton picks himself up. And gets himself a free kick. Can you believe it again? Hilton towards Holland. Here comes Silvani. Storming through the forward line. Gives it to Kuta. Kuta's in trouble. Around one. Puts it inside 50 once again. He needs Whitnall. He needs someone.
Great mark.
But not the Richmond defence. Porter's unable to spoil Benny Gale. And he takes a beauty.
That's where he's one of the best in the competition, Brendan Gale. He reads the play so well, playing a kick behind. It just takes a solid mark to relieve a bit of pressure.
And interesting, Jay, Scott Caprioli coming off for a rest.
Andrew Kellaway with a lazy left foot kick out towards the contest between Jason Tawney and Lance Whitnall. Tawney able to get the ball to Gasper. Gasper out to the wing. Marking contest, there was none. Mansfield was advantaged by that kick. Campbell left lamenting, and Mansfield will kick the Blues back into attack. In front of a crowd of about 85,000 people here at the MCG, the loser goes out and the winner to play Brisbane next week. Big stakes, aren't they? You just cannot afford to make a blue. That middle kick was a little short. Oh, crunched was nice, and he does get the free kick.
Tell you what, if you get a kick out here at the moment, you have to earn it. You put your head down, it nearly gets taken off. Good approach from Matthew Nice, just to attack the ball. He knew he was going to get crunched, but he just wore it, and he's the beneficiary of the free kick.
And boys, an apt word, crunch. I was sitting 60 metres away. I could hear it from here.
Gives it to Gasper.
Poor kick.
Well, nerves are obviously playing a part here for Bowler. He tried to sock it away. There was no one home. Picked up by Bowden. Goes on to the funny-looking right boot. Silvani, he can't pick it up. Eventually he does. Back to Favola from a standing start. He goes back towards Koutoufides in the centre. Stands his ground and holds it well in front of Tawney.
Right. You can see he's got to play a good game if the Blues are to win this.
He thought about Lappin going one side, but now goes more directly towards Whitnall and Co down in the forward line. Allen was there.
Ducked his head.
Solid. Lappin a chance now. Enjoys the situation, but he can't bend it back far enough, and it's out of bounds on the ball.
It was a good decision, that one. Whitnall came in solidly, but when the player ducks his head, the umpire is prepared to let play go on.
And so Broderick does, as he gives it to Leon Cameron.
Cameron in the left back pocket for the Tigers. Kicks the ball close to the boundary line. It will bounce away from Joel Bowden and over. 16 plays to Richmond have the two goals on the scoreboard.
And already, Robbo, there's just a lot of targets being missed. Players just haven't adapted to the tempo or the pressure yet.
So the boundary umpire to throw it in about 60 metres around from the Carlton goal. Porter and Brendan Gale. Porter from behind, Gale in front. Front on tackle provided by Mansfield. Umpire will bounce about 53 metres from the Blues' goal.
Both teams preparing to make a change. Scott Caprioli warming up to come back on, and Clinton King for the Tigers.
So with just over 2 minutes left, Richmond by 14 points, 16 plays to. Disconcerting thing for the Blues would be that they haven't added a goal, haven't kicked a goal yet in this first term. Hickmott
kicks it to the goal square. Whitnall in front, couldn't take the mark. Look at the Tigers get back. They had 4-1. Knights is caught, dispossessed, got the hand pass away to Hulme. He shares it with Gasper. In turn, the Tigers get away through Chaffee. Chaffee to a 2-on-1, which favours the Blues. Favola couldn't take the mark. Silvani at the front. Handball Plunkett. Over the top, Fletcher to straighten up and kick it towards full forward. Not a real good kick, and it covers the players in that area and rolls over for a boundary throw in left forward pocket for Carlton.
Plunkett off. And Camporelli back on, and Clinton King coming on for the Tigers, replacing Paul Broderick.
Pretty good effort there by Lappin to just restrain Matthew Knights. Gale to a dangerous area as far as Richmond are concerned, but it is controlled well by Andrew Kellaway. Goes short, not too bad either. The long kick had no real chance of keeping possession for Richmond, so he goes short to Ben Holland. Holland goes short in turn and finds Ray Hall. Hall is still inside his defensive 50-metre zone. Hickmott mining the mark. Hall to go to the far side. Lovely long kick. It's gone 65 metres with the breeze. Mark taken out there by Gasper. He's come a long way down the ground. Sziller is a target. And King chips in front of Sziller and marks. He's still too far out to score. He'll look to play on. And he does. He'll kick it in the Richardson Ottens direction. In front, the mark is taken by Richardson.
Clever kick. Very clever kick. And as soon as Matthew Richardson took the mark, if you have a look, 5 metres behind, Stephen Silvani just unable to go with him, dropped the head in despair, because he's just an incredible athlete, Matthew Richardson. Not only is he one of the quickest in the league, he also has incredible endurance. And you've got a feel for Stephen Silvani, with so many games under the belt, having to cover every square inch of the MCG chasing Matthew Richardson. He'll play clever, Silvani. He'll zone off. He'll try and cut a few of the zones off and catch Richardson coming back to him, but it's going to be impossible to cut him off all day.
There's the shot from behind Matthew Richardson. Not much of an angle, and it swings away drastically with the breeze through for a behind.
All of a sudden now, Ann is having a bit of a go on with Freeborn, yeah, who had a few words to say about the kick. That's one thing that opposition teams have always done. We did it at Hawthorn for many times. When his kicking's not going according to plan, get in his ear. Bowden. Get in his head and try and annoy him.
In the meantime, gets on with it. They're still going. They'll be going when the siren sounds.
Get the checkbook out, boys.
Beaumont towards a fairly congested centre wing. Hickmott was at the back and he goes again. He pounces on it. Koutoufides tries to come over the top. Kellaway comes in strongly. It's quarter time. And the yellow and black rises in the stands. They'd be pretty happy with their charges first quarter. 7 effective scoring shots to only 2. And a couple of missed altogether for both sides. Tiger goal kickers are Joel Bowden and Matthew Richardson. Wayne Brittain still yet to see his side kick a goal, as the umpire having a quiet chat there with Scotty Freeborn. It's quarter time. Richmond at 2-5, Carlton 2 behind. As you would expect, tough, uncompromising start to a knockout final, but also some superb acting, Jason.
Oh, there has been. And look, this is where you can be smart. Take yourself out of that contest. Players are going to act, and if you manage to get a free kick and kick a goal, it's a very costly error by the person giving away the free kick. So you've got to know when you can actually get involved in a bit of byplay and when you've just got to steer clear of it. This one, they verbalised Matthew Richardson after he missed another shot for goal. It's tough conditions, it's blustery, and they'll be happy to get into his head and try to take his focus off the game. There's Tawney coming in on Darren Hulme. Or might have been Andrew Kellaway coming in. A little bit here between Cooter and Brendan Gale. It's just everyone's trying to fly the flag. They're trying to get to some sort of physical advantage.
Well, Richmond lead by 15 points, but it's interesting. Carlton dominated for the first 5 minutes. The Tigers for the remainder of the term, but the margin is only 2.5 kicks. It's 2-5. To 2 behinds at quarter time. And let's now join Paul Salmon for his impressions of that first quarter.
Yeah, thanks, Sandy. We're just going to look at a couple of respective forward 50 setups. This one's the Tigers. One there's Richardson, two is Ottens, and three is Campbell with his opponent Mackay. They're the running patterns. They'll create space behind Richardson there. Beaumont was the blue arrow in front. He's the sweeper for the Blues. You can see what the Tigers are endeavouring to do here. The ball's going to come in long into that space. And it was pretty effective. Richardson's pretty good backing back with the fly to the ball. He caught Silvani on the hop. He's still got the space there. Campbell and Ottens have cleared it for him. And he got the free and converted for their first goal for the Tigers. Conversely, at the Blues end, there's Whitnall highlighted with his direct opponent. And Tigers are dropping sweepers off the back of stop plays. And really, Gasper's prepared to run off his opponent for Valva and cover. There's Chaffee. There's Knights in screen. So there's a four against one situation for the Tigers. And they really are squeezing the life out of the Blues. And as we'll see in this shot, they do clear it effectively. And all the work is up the ground with Richardson providing the options. So pretty impressive defensively, the Tigers so far.
Greg Hutchison has left the Tiger huddle. Here he is with Ozzie.
Hutchie, great start. You'd be happy with that.
Yeah, look, Ozzie, the hardness and intensity has been fantastic. We've just got to maintain it now for the rest of the game.
We're about to go. Thanks, mate.
Yeah, good on you. Thank you.
Oh, I think we've already started in some quarters. Look at this.
It's like two bulls just butting heads, isn't it? And poor old Brian Sheehan trying to say, cut it out, fellas.
So the second quarter is underway. It's Richmond leading by 15 points. Allen trying to come in over the top. He was looking for Camporelli, but he doesn't find him. Picked up by Sziller, and he kicks a high ball to the half forward line. McKay smashes it back towards Camporelli again. Shrugs one tackle and gets it clear to Hulme. That's better off to Bradley. Now Houlihan. Carlton go forward. Houlihan with a left foot wobbly old mongrel punt. Puts it straight into the stand.
That's the pressure that just has to be continued by Richmond around the middle of the ground. To stop the flow, I mean, no matter how good they are up at the forward line, if the kicks come up there ordinarily like that, the forwards have got to be geniuses to capitalise.
Chaffee from the back pocket. Heads long towards centre wing. Camporelli copped a hard one in the first quarter and he gets dumped again, but he's okay. Sziller and Coa right on him once more. And the Tigers continue to pour on the pressure.
And Sandy, we didn't get much time to speak to Greg Hutchison at quarter time, but I was chatting to him before we went to air. He said he's very happy with their performance in the first quarter. Delighted at this stage.
And seven effective scoring shots to two. Tells the story of that first term. Koutoufides tries to lock it up. Sziller can't get clear. Koutoufides has him. Camporelli ties up Broderick and there'll be a bounce. The Blues bench, Freeborn, Prendergast, Trent Houghton, and Christou, Ange at the end. A bounce on centre wing, Allen just pokes it over the boundary line. Wayne Campbell sees it there.
And at some stage you would expect the aggression, the physicalness, the physical intensity and everything just to drop off and a little bit more free-flowing play to develop. But at the moment, it doesn't look likely.
Broderick got it out to Gale, who flicks it up towards right half forward. He wanted Rogers. McKay defends. And defends very well.
Sandy, just a stat off the ball, so to speak. Footy's biggest pests in yesterday's paper. 20 guys named, no Stephen Sziller.
Well,
I'll tell you what, he would up there with Liberatore in my book.
It's a timing error. It's got to be.
He is just, he's terrific at it. He's not the classy player, but he just, like Danny Frawley recruited him from St Kilda. Obviously, the Saints thought he wasn't going to play a part in their resurgence, planned resurgence. He gubs to Richmond, and Danny Frawley's got faith in him. Matthew Knights trying to get past. He'll get the hand pass back. Plunkett's attack on Knights, but the umpire's found a free kick just a second before that, and it will go to Ryan Houlihan. Blues pretty stagnant, can't get any flow through the midfield. Houlihan to kick the ball close to the forward 50 metre line, close to the boundary line, and it's punched over. Richmond would be reasonably satisfied with that, and the Blues just have to get away into the open if they're to kick a score. They haven't found their first goal yet. 2-5 Richmond, two behinds the Blues, Gale and Porter. Gale in front, read that boundary throw in beautifully, Brendan Gale, and punched it a long way away from the Blues goal. Bradley can't get past Rogers. He can. Handball over the top, McKay. Bradley, look away handball. Plunkett, who was a good player last week, kicks the ball towards Whitnall, but chipping in front, and the mark is taken by Ray Hall. Disciplined play all over the ground so far, and they're following instructions to the letter, the Tigers. Ray Hall with the football. Short kick. That's okay. Broderick shares it. Tawney at centre halfback. Lobs the ball high. It'll hold up in the breeze. And Fletcher will take the mark. He will play on to Houlihan. Back to Fletcher. Off the left. He's a right foot kick, but that's pretty good. And Favola has marked.
Ooh, it was nearly off.
He took a couple of steps after taking the mark and then decided to go back and kick the ball long.
Kuta.
In towards full forward. He's got it and he'll kick the Blues' first goal. That's Kuta, of course.
You can see it a mile off, Robbo.
You did, Jason. You picked that beautifully.
Kuta ran deep into the goal square and Brendan Tawala was good enough to realise if he got a quick long kick down there, he might be able to get a one-on-one contest. We saw it happen last week. Whenever they isolate Koutoufides, they kick it high to him. Look at the long kick. It carries the pack. And at the back, it's Anthony Koutoufides, who just works his opponent under the ball. It was actually Brendan Gale, the big fellow, that he just shoulders him under the ball. He does it well. Just a subtle nudge. You get away with that. Trots in for the simplest of goals.
No such thing as a wind advantage here, but it appears as though the ball is carrying a little further when it gets up into the breeze at that right end of screen.
Ian Prendergast is on the ground, has been an infringement, and it's going down to Carlton. Here's the man who's just come off. He was possibly given a bit of a welcome by Ray Hall, and he's finding himself with a shot at goal in his first touch for the game.
And Sandy, Ray Hall, know he's in for a game today. Young Prendergast, I saw him last week out, last week's game against Adelaide. He's got an amazing level of endurance fitness, so he'll be running around all day long.
Well, he's only played seven games. He's booted 3 goals, 4. In his brief career,
that's terrific because, you know, in a final, they're persevering with the youth, which is terrific.
Here he goes for the Blues second in 30 seconds coming back, but all too late and one behind.
And they're going at it again, Hall and Prendergast. It was Favola that he came on to replace, which sent Gasper back onto Porter and Hall onto Prendergast.
And Broderick's coming off for a spell too for the Tigers while King returns to the action. Bowden thinks about going short to Kellaway and eventually does. Andrew Kellaway tucked in the back pocket has Gale on centre wing long. That's where he heads. Allen is there with him, but Whitnall's in front, pokes it down, claimed by Hall, given away to Chaffee, off to King. Tigers out of the danger zone again, up towards Richardson. Richardson goes again, pushed towards the line by Fletcher, kept in by Rogers. It's wobbling along the line until Silvani comes along. And we've got a throw in.
He was a bit stiff, Matthew Richardson, because he'd set up the 5 or 10 metre break on Stephen Silvani, but the kick didn't favour him. It held up, and Silvani was able to get there, make the contest.
Fletcher was looking for a free kick off the ball. Allen. Carlton getting the only goal so far in this quarter. Don't forget, for all your finals news and action, i7sport.com.au. As we go to the throw-in once again, Gale pokes it down towards Campbell. Benny Gale, Benny, held it for a long time. Finally gets it away to Sziller. Stephen Sziller up towards the half-forward line. McKay couldn't take it cleanly. Slapped out the back. Here's a chance now. Richardson going across the ground. Big test for Chaffee. He's going to have to beat a couple. Prendergast came crashing through. Raymond Hall. He gets caught. Caught from behind. She's warming up now. The Tigers go for goal. They go right across the face of goal. Carlton Hand's not happy.
That is absolutely ridiculous. The player had all day to get rid of the ball. He was caught red-handed with it. No free kick.
I'll tell you what, Joel Bowden missed a gilt-edged opportunity to put another one on the board for the Tigers, missing everything on his favourite left foot.
Richardson and Gale. Hotton was there as well. Hickmon. Koutoufides lurking. Still lurking. And a bounce.
Nick Daffy just waiting for his opportunity. And just to keep you updated, Andrew Kellaway with Adrian Hickmott, Rogers and McKay, Bowden and Beaumont. That'll be interesting, won't it? Joel Bowden has had a wonderful season for the Tigers and he's already kicked a goal for Richmond in this game. 2-5 plays, 1-3. Richmond lead by 8 points.
Jason, how do you think Stephen Silvani's handling this running of Richardson?
Well, you can see he's having a spell at every opportunity because he is getting run ragged, covering more ground than he would be accustomed to. But he's an old campaigner. He lacks in endurance compared to Richardson, he'll certainly make up for in smarts.
Blues a little fortunate there. Richmond were away with Clinton King and the umpire decided to bounce the ball. So not giving them all that much time to get rid of the ball from the congestion. There was a chance for Camporelli. King's handball gathered by Hilton. Handball internally on Cameron. His kick will land the ball at half forward. And the mark dropped there by Silvani. Gathered McKay. Hickmott over the top. Silvani.
spins out of trouble and then delivers beautifully to Hulme. Now this is the run through the middle that the Blues are looking for. Darren Hulme's short kick has been strongly marked by Porter in front of Gasper. Missed his target by an absolute kilometre. Bradley was there to gather the crumbs. Spins, drops it on his boot. Houlihan has taken the mark. No, drop. Gathered by King. Ball spills in favour of the Tigers. Slip handball by Campbell. The umpire on the wrong side couldn't see that. Gasper the recipient. Gasper towards half forward. And Mansfield couldn't take it.
Well,
Richardson
on the way.
From the back. He's dropped it. He'll have another go. Richardson from 50. A mongrel kick in towards full forward. Back there is Ottens. Manton, he shrugs the tackle. He'll go in and kick a goal. Brad Ottens. Brad Ottens has kicked the third goal for the Tigers.
Well, it was a great effort from Brad Ottens. There's an old adage that all the coaches use, and that is, as soon as you go to ground, the team's one short. Richardson burst on it and then gave himself the worst bounce you've ever seen. Soss was chasing, put a little bit of pressure on. Now have a look at Glenn Manton. The one thing you can't do is lose your footing. As soon as you do that, Ottens is all on his own. He strolls in and kicks a beauty.
Ottens gets the goal and Soss is saying to himself, I didn't realise I'd been for such an afternoon. Boy. So the Tigers answer the early Carlton goal this quarter. Hickmott tries to rip it out of the centre, but there's been a whistle. It'll come back. It will be a Carlton ball. Camporelli again finds himself at the bottom of the pack.
He's been on the bottom of the pack four times, yeah. And there have been Richmond players that have pummeled him into the ground.
Stephen Sziller not far away.
I find it interesting that with Matthew Allen having a spell, it's not Porter that's gone into the ruck. He's staying as the tall forward, and Trent Houghton is the one running on the ball.
Camporelli wide to the outer side, and Hickmott. Whitnall, limited opportunities. In towards the forward line. And another throw in. 3-5, plays 1-3. So the Tigers through Ottens getting one goal in this term. Koutoufides ambling into an open goal for Carlton. They only kicked 8 in the round 11 clash. Here's another opportunity for Hulme. If it bounces, if it bounces!
Gee, they desperately needed that one, the Blues.
I'm not sure about whether the defensive work of Richmond at the boundary throw-in was as good as Danny Frawley would have been. There was too big a gap here for Darren Hulme. Watch that.
Yeah, he just lost him in traffic. He ran right through the middle. And unfortunately for the Tigers, he finished off well, but it was a much-needed goal for the Blues. They've been more than matched in the hardness around the contest by the Tigers, and they haven't been able to break free. One of the few opportunities there.
Matthew Allen having a spell with Brendan Favola as we watch Trent Houghton do the ruck work, but he's beaten pointlessly. Ottens gets it again and kicks it forward. Richardson and Silvani. Fletcher is back there as a smaller defender, and he gathers the ball quite nicely, and he's prepared to kick it not that far down the line. There really was no one to kick it to, so at least he's made it a 50-50 circumstance for the Blues, but it's certainly in the danger zone. It's only 60 metres from the Richmond goal. Boundary throw in, Koutoufides, Ottens in front, Houghton, he's got rid of by Ottens. Ottens still has the ball, able to get the hand pass. Cameron got his boot to it, only as far as Plunkett. In turn, Beaumont. Now Beaumont, he's in lots of trouble, isn't he? IG McKay's under pressure. That forward line of Richmond working overtime to keep the ball in there alive.
How about the Kellaway tackle?
They have been brilliant around the contest, the Tigers. They have been a little bit more ferocious than Carlton at this stage. And I've got to tell you, the great work of Brad Ottens in the ruck. Pretty handy when you can pull him up and give Brendan Gale a spell.
12 minutes remaining in the half. Koutoufides. Chaffee at the back.
Been a free kick to the Blues.
It'll come back.
Prendergast. Bumped too early.
So Prendergast on centre wing.
Fourth free kick that Ray Hall has given away.
He looks towards Whitnall.
Oh!
Well, it went past him and it bounced off the chest of Porter, and he got the shock of his life. King tries to flick it wide, finishes with Hilton. Hilton's on half-back, goes towards centre wing, finds Chaffee off to Campbell. The skipper now, wide to Raymond Hall, another one, and he's got Hilton. Hilton's on left half forward, the kick is wide. Phil directed and out of bounds on the ball.
Yeah, just needed the long kick to a more attacking position towards the centre corridor. Just a little bit of finessing down the line cost them in the end.
But at the moment, the Tigers having the answers. Well, Hickmott just hit that one.
About a centimetre to spare on that one.
I'm glad he didn't have to juggle it. He kicks towards centre wing once again. Porter is in very late.
Great mark.
That's an excellent grab because Porter came charging and Kellaway stood in front and took the grab. Short to Bowden. He can go wide to the outer side. There are Tigers running everywhere and Ray Hall is one of them. Hall is away. He's on centre wing. He wants to try and pop it over the top, but he couldn't. He tries to go all the way. Goes onto the left foot, passes into the pocket, and Ottens takes the mark.
Gee, I thought for a moment that Ray Hall had messed it up. I thought he'd draw the Carlton opponent and then handball over the top of Tippendale. But in the end, he knew what he was doing. He was looking further afield. He saw Ottens one out, making a lead in the pocket, and in the end, made life a little bit difficult. He got around a couple, but then the kick just favoured Ottens. It really stretched him. It's a terrific control with the one hand. He's having a decent sort of influence now, Brad Ottens, in this second quarter.
Tough kick for Brad Ottens. You give Ray Hall congratulations for backing himself, don't you, as a young player by games play. And we're watching Ottens go for goal. It is floating close, but no cigar there for the Tigers. Just a behind to Brad Ottens. He's kicked one goal, two, as has Matthew Richardson. Danny Frawley, yes, we're on the edge of our seats here too, Danny, as we watch Fletcher bring the ball back in for the Blues. He goes straight down the ground. He's looking for the player there in Beaumont. Prendergast was in there. Tivendale, Bradley gathers, throws it onto his left boot, high in the air. It'll go to a contest. The ball hits the ground. Now, who can gather this? McKay can. King was very good, but he got the ball away to Whitnall. He in turn to Plunkett. Plunkett to Silvani. Now he's got to hang on to it or go short. He goes too short. And the mark is taken by Matthew Knights. Now quickly, it will rebound on behalf of the Tigers. Out wide, the mark is taken by Rogers. He goes into the pocket beautifully off the left boot and finds Hilton only 40 metres from goal, but a difficult angle.
And Robbo, I'll just chime in for a minute. I know some coaches love the idea of pushing forwards up. Silvani had nowhere to go then. He had no options in the full forward line.
Yes. It was a good option to run off because Matthew Richardson didn't chase him. But unfortunately, he nearly got caught coming back the other way, Soz.
Beautiful delivery by Matthew Rogers. Hilton with a shot at goal and scores a behind.
See, I think there's a few of them struggling to work out the effect that breeze having. That was dead set behind. He's called it out in the full.
Incredible. Well,
it was a clear behind. We were directly behind that. That wasn't even close to the point post.
So the boundary umpire and the goal umpire down there in the at that end of the ground, a little questionable, that decision. Richmond will control the football. Cameron, good blocking. It was terrific work provided by Sziller. In the middle of the ground, Tivendale.
Look away,
handball, Tawney, Bowden. Left foot, snap at goal. No, it's Ray Hall, actually. Ray Hall has kicked Richmond's fourth goal. And Richmond 4-6-30, Luke Carlton 2-3-15.
Well, he gave away a few free kicks early on, Ray Hall, but he's certainly come into the game. He's had eight possessions now, helped himself to a goal. It was a beauty. And there was a magnificent little hand pass in the middle, and it was Greg Tivendale. Have a look at this. Oh, no, it wasn't. It was Tawney. Jason Tawney was the one. Just shot it out, drew the opponent, and a great finish from Ray Hall. You've called Joel Bowden. Well, he's kicked one goal and three out in the full.
Well, the Tigers have the answers at the moment. 15 points the margin. It was 15 points at quarter time. Camporelli out of the centre for Carlton. A high ball. Beaumont shows courage as he backs into the pack. Tivendale gives the hand pass away to Cameron. Away go the Tigers again. Kellaway can run. He looks down to the forward line. The lead is on.
He hasn't paid it
to Richardson. He tries to dash clear, and he almost threw that football. Kellaway's in trouble. Towards the line. Houlihan misses it. He needs assistance, and he gets it now. They're out of trouble for the moment to Hulme on the half-back line. Hulme looks towards Lappin. A little too much on it. Chaffee's at the back. Decides to give a little ground and come across to Holland.
Lappin just three kicks.
Gee, loose players in the middle of the ground.
Gaspar, even wider. Almost smothered. That was good work. Towards centre wing. Favola's in trouble. His soccer's off the ground. Past Caparelli and over the boundary line.
They're applying enormous pressure, Richmond. We're just not used to Carlton missing as many targets as they do. This is the worm burner. And a good decision by the umpire. It looked like it just bounced.
Bump ball.
They're putting some great pressure on the Tigers, really causing some errors. from the normally skillful Blues players.
7.5 minutes remaining in the half. Holland couldn't trap it. Koutoufides can to Camporelli. But they're finding goals. Very difficult to buy at the moment. Kellaway holds up yet another attack and decides to head to the outer side. Prendergast gets there a little late.
You can't expect to win games at finals football with the scoreboard showing well and truly past the halfway mark of the second quarter, 2-3-15.
Well, it's interesting because I think in their round 11 clash, Carlton kicked 8 goals, 8. So perhaps it says something about the defence of this side as Tivendale goes with a long bomb, a mighty bomb. And one behind as it comes off the hands of the pack.
Rory Hilton with the big leap. Looked like he was going to take one of the screamers of the season. Just coming over the top with a great long kick from Tivendale. Have a look at that for a ride. Just couldn't get both hands up.
16 points is the margin. The kick in is okay. Finds Manton. Goes back to Fletcher. Forced to go very short. McKay. Silvani is on further down the ground. He can play on, maybe go over the top to Freeborn. And that is successful. He could go into the middle to Camporelli, who decides to go long in the direction of Favola. Little tap on was quite friendly. Hume was tackled, didn't have the ball. Kicked off the ground by Lappin, but the free kick is with Darren Hume, who was nowhere near in possession of the ball. The anticipation and the determination by Jason Tawney was first class, but it was interference by the Tiger player.
Just played it very cleverly, Darren Hume. He knew he was going to be tackled if he took possession, so he just played the ball along in front of him.
Is there a time you think, I know you're watching this now, Jason, and it's a blatant free kick, isn't it?
Yeah, Chaffee just took him out of the play.
Is there a time where a goal like this is important, even though we're a long way from the end of the siren? I mean, if it had gone to Richmond and the game had broken to, say, 22 points, now Carlton have got a chance to bring it back.
Oh, no doubt. I think Richmond's playing at a very high level at the moment. They're actually controlling the game. So it's important that while that's happening, Carlton stay in touch, which means they need to make the most of every opportunity. And this one would just get them back within a couple of kicks.
We saw the kick from, I think it was Matthew Richardson, from much the same area in the first term, float away to the right. Darren Hume's kick is a beauty. It's a goal to the Blues, his second.
Been a good player, Darren Hume. There were plenty of raves about his job on Andrew McLeod last week. A different role today. He's certainly gathering a bit of the ball. He's had 9 possessions now, a couple of marks. But just see Mark Chaffee, he commits. He thinks Hume's going to take it. So he says, I've got to tackle him, I've got to take him out of play. And as soon as he took him to ground and Hume hadn't taken possession, he just tapped the ball forward. Very clever, Darren Hume. And most importantly, a straight kick after the free kick.
17 goals now for the season for the little Frankston bomber, Darren Hume. He's kicked a couple today. Out of the middle, McKay. Can't shrug the tackle, but he tried to push it forward. The Tigers squabbling for it. Ball towards the half forward line. Campbell takes the mark. He's called to play on. He does so to Hilton. Hilton goes in towards the lead at full forward. It's a beauty. And Rogers will go back for the quick answering goal.
Magnificent hands from Wayne Campbell that released Rory Hilton. And then he was clever enough not to blaze away. There are a couple of players making space. He just had to pick them out. Look at this quick hand pass. They're playing on it every opportunity, keeping the ball flowing. And he doesn't blaze. He chips it to Matthew Rogers, who created space on his own.
Man who came over from South Adelaide in 1994. Has a chance to again make it a 16-point margin. Matty Rogers kicks the goal. 16 points is again the margin. Rogers' first goal.
I think the Tigers have stunned a few here at the MCG. They probably expected it to be the other way around, with Carlton perhaps controlling the game. And Danny Frawley's cried so long for a bit of respect for this side. Perhaps they're earning it now. And after a goal at the other end of Hume, they bounce back in the best possible fashion, scoring one themselves as an immediate reply.
Carlton coach Wayne Brittain looking on with 5 minutes left in the first half. 5-7 to 3-3. And they seem to be affecting a lot of centre clearances, don't they? Campbell's tackle on Fletcher was good. Tivendale, Tawney, now Sziller. Left foot kick for goal by Tawney.
Oh, he's paid it.
It was a blatant holding infringement against Manton. And Ottens, this is the goal that I was talking about just a moment ago. 16 points the lead for Richmond in a low scoring game, 22 points at half time. We're closing in on that break, 5 minutes left. Brad Ottens to go for his second goal. He's very close to the goal. The angle is his greatest area of concern. Player on the mark is only about 5 metres out. Runs close to the player on the mark and pops it through for a goal.
Well, they're doing everything right at the moment, the Tigers. They're winning their possession in the midfield. They've been a little bit harder at the ball around the contest. That was where they had to get plenty of ball to get it forward. And an amazing statistic. We thought they had the advantage with a couple of big forwards. The Tigers, they've taken 13 marks in their attacking 50. And Carlton have only taken three. 10 of those have been contested. And Richmond also dominating the centre clearance, 7-2.
The Tigers now holding the biggest lead in this game to date with under 5 minutes remaining. They're winning the hit-outs, and can they take it out of the centre clearance once again as they've done so often so far? Allen can't pick it up cleanly. They desperately need a goal before half-time. Freeborn gets it away towards Prendergast. Another one to Lappin. Carlton go to half-forward. That's better. And Favola out on the lead.
He's a long kick. He's the mark's about a metre inside the 50-metre line. So he'd kick from 53, 54 metres, but I don't think he'll struggle with the distance. It was a beautiful lead. He does play like a traditional full forward. It was a good lead, beautiful kick, a good set of hands there. But it'll take an extraordinary kick with the blustery conditions.
27 goals and 23 behinds for his season. Yeah. Pretty good looking kick.
Gee, it went late, didn't it?
Yeah.
Well, that was basically online, judging by the goal umpire's reaction, until 10 or 15 metres. Then it turned suddenly or sharply left and the goal umpire took off.
21 points the margin. Oh, Fletcher was a flyer over Campbell, but he couldn't take the mark. Tivendale gets ridden into the ground. He's got it on half back with Fletcher on the mark. Hickmont tried to spoil. Kuda comes over the back, but he couldn't take the mark. Oh, Chappie's caught by McKay. An excellent tackle. The advantage will be paid, and Pluckett's away. So too is Carlton towards Whitnall.
Sticky fingers, wasn't it, by Whitnall?
Well, he's seen very little of the leather so far today with limited opportunities. He puts it over towards Favola, but it's not a good kick. Favola's back where he was only moments ago. Thought about Allen, then chips back in towards half forward. Almost the mark, not going to be paid. Back to Favola. This time he gets a crack at goal and misses again.
Gee, it was actually the right idea from Lance Whitnall. He saw Favola stealing in on the far side, but the kick just had a little bit too much carry on it. And in the end, a wasted opportunity for Carlton.
These are the chances that they've got to sneak one through, don't they? Because it's 20 points and it's a handy 20-point advantage for Richmond.
They'd like to cut into that before half-time,
Robert.
I agree,
Jason.
They've got under 3 minutes to do that. Cameron. Feature of his kicking is his pinpoint accuracy. This time he comes towards his tall timber, and Kuda stands alone. Gives a little ground to go to Hulme. Bradley is there with him. Hulme, too far out to score. Ignores the lead. Prendergast goes to Bradley on all fours. He's turned it over. Richo's in trouble now. On go the skates. He gets the hand pass wide. Back towards Koutoufides. Kuda's caught. Loses the footy. Trying to get through is Favola. Short little chip is clever and it's good. And the mark is taken inside 50 by Prendergast.
Bradley's in a bit of trouble back in the centre there, Sandy, where he slipped over.
He is. I think when he gave the hand pass out, he might have got collected. Just a solid knock.
This is the score that has to be capitalised on by the Blues and Ian Prendergast.
He's kicked one behind so far today.
It's a goal.
There, it is there. A big goal for Carlton.
Gee, that is a very important one. We said they needed to eat into that 20-point margin prior to the halftime break. But again, it was from a similar side. We've seen Matthew Richardson have a couple that have gone left to right from that angle. Well, that one went right to left. Here's the poor kick coming in, Bradley. Well, I think he just gets collected by Matthew Knights. Certainly just might have knocked the wind out of him, nothing more than that.
Craig Bradley with eight possessions, Matthew Knights on screen with eight possessions and one mark to Matthew Knights. Blues a chance through Plunkett, getting into the game. He's kicked the ball up towards half forward, and a good mark is taken back there by Holland. Quickly onto the scene, Brett Allen. Holland gets to his feet, looking down the ground. Sea of faces, it's a terrific crowd here for this final. Hand pass to Gasper, nearly run down by Hickmott, puts some pressure on, and the kick goes out wide towards the wing, where the contest is with good shepherd by Hulme, gave the chance to Beaumont, handball is okay, Lappin, he's got Hulme in support, decides to hang on to the ball. Gee, that handball was on for a long while. Hulme gets it back, Whitnall has been quiet, Whitnall into the pocket, no mark to Favola, he keeps it alive, chance for Cooter, little handball Lappin. The kick by Lappin, there is a scrambly one and hits the behind post. 43 plays, 29, 14 points. They really are scrounging for a score. Danny Frawley just excited. I'm sure every fan here, the Richmond and the Blues fans, are on the edge of their seats. We've got a minute left in the half. Can the Blues scramble a score? Cooter!
Yes.
Left foot step off the ground, he kicks the goal.
Well, Cooter's kicked his second. And I think Danny Frawley would have been very pleased with the job that was being done on him by Duncan Kellaway. He's only had the 11 possessions, but all of a sudden he's got a couple of goals next to his name. And more importantly, the Blues have just come back in the last 5 or 7 minutes. They've really dominated play. They've had all the possession down their end. And all of a sudden, if Richmond go in only a kick or so ahead, I think they'd feel hardly done by.
And you just need an ounce of luck to win football matches, don't you?
Well, under a minute remaining in the half. Koutoufides has two, Hulme has two, and Carlton is back. Not for a moment we thought they were gone.
Set of clearances they've had the last two or three.
King, it's smothered. Lappin. He's built like a stick insect and looks like an unmade bed, but he can play to the 50-metre line. Almost a chance for Prendergast. Hickmott on all fours, tries to get it out. Camporelli with a little soccer tactic, keeps it in the area. Out it comes once more towards Lappin. It passes him, he's got to go back and get it. The clock continues to tick down, he leaves it for Freeborn. He left it a little too long. Hilton closed on him. Bowden gives it back to Hilton. They want the siren. Campbell pops it over the top. Bowden in trouble. McKay hassling him to the line and it's over.
I'll tell you what, Matthew Lappin just realised he's got his hands on his head. All he had to do was provide a shepherd for Scott Freeborn and he was away. He would have delivered the ball into the attacking 50. But the Tiger defender just ghosted straight past Matthew Lappin and tackled him. And a wasted opportunity again for the Blues. But they are definitely got a run on at the moment.
8 points the margin. The Tigers won't mind the siren. They can regroup. Hickmott. Allen, here's a go for Carlton. They need a mark. Allen towards Cooter. He gets an unkind bounce. Gasper is there as well. Kellaway taking the ground by Favola. It's half time. Big half of football here at the MCG and a knockout semi-final. Kellaway, Favola, Prendergast, Hall.
It started like that, Sandy, and the first half has finished exactly the same way.
Four goals, two in that term to Richmond, and 5-3 to the Blues.
So the Blues closed the gap. It was 15 points at quarter time. It is 8 points now. Richmond, a 6-7-43. Carlton, 5-5-35.
Fifteen points was the margin at quarter time. It's back to 8 points with a late surge by Carlton. They're 5-5-35, trailing Richmond 6-7-43. As we check the leading scorers on the ground at the moment, Hulme, Koutoufides, two for the Blues. Ottens has two for Richmond. He's their only multiple scorer. Rogers, Bowden, Richardson and Ray Hall all have singles. But I would imagine that Wayne Brittain would be very happy with that scoreline at half-time and that late surge.
Yeah, I think so. It's been an enthralling contest. I thought Richmond were tremendous early. They really did their job. They did their homework. They seemed to be controlling the game. But a couple of late ones from Carlton, you just get the feeling they're ready to really have a crack at them.
Now, Soss might sleep well tonight.
He's covered a few miles, I've got to tell you. Richo has been running rampant. He has led and marked everything. And he's certainly running far and wide. That was the free kick. That was the one that got Richo going. He kicked the goal with that one. But unfortunately for Richo, he just missed a couple of other ones. You can just see plenty of contest going on, a lot of body work. But a couple of times, you can just see Soss caught off the mark there. A poor bounce. Otherwise, he would have run into an open goal. And an even poorer kick. So he's had a few opportunities, Richo. Just hasn't perhaps got the return that he could have. And Brad Ottens has been very good as well.
Well, I think the trump card as far as Carlton was going to be concerned today was number 43, yeah. Kuta, has showed flashes of brilliance, hasn't he? And, of course, has been in the goals.
Well, he has. I thought they did it. Duncan Kellaway was tremendous early. He went forward. He actually had Gasper in the end. But the two goals are the important part there. He wasn't getting the midfield statistics that he's had over the last month. But all of a sudden, he kicked a couple of very important goals. And that's really what got the Blues back in the game. There's that one off the ground. Just an opportunist goal, that one, but an important one.
Yeah, that was one of the late ones for Carlton that brought that margin back to 8 points at half-time. There's been plenty of rough stuff. A lot of boys are going to be happy to be receiving a little bit of attention at the half-time break.
Bit of byplay between Beaumont and Hilton. He actually stooged the umpire there. He got the free kick, but then he wasted it. And wasn't Beaumont pretty happy with that? He thought he'd go for another one. And funny, one of the common denominators there. Rory Hilton likes to get in amongst it. And Scott Kemp really copping a tough one there from Ray Hall. Richo, and now this was just after he missed another shot for goal. Scott Freeborn got into it and Richo didn't like it. They were playing some mind games with him, trying to take his focus off the game. And certainly you'd be pretty happy if you could get him to concentrate on something other than the ball, Matthew Richardson. But it was lively early and there were plenty. Oh, this was great, wasn't it? Porter and Hall just going at it. They weren't wrestling. Can't call that wrestling. What do you call it?
That's like two bulls in the cattle yards and they're not happy.
It's the old warm-up you used to do with teammates, hip and shoulder. There's a good one on Darren Hume, who was over the ball. Here's Kuta and Brendan Gale going at it. They might have copped a little one high. There's another tough bump coming in on Matthew Knight. So I'll tell you what, you've had to earn the kicks. I mean, the courage is all about putting your head over the ball, eyes on the ball and attacking it, but the players have made you earn it, haven't they?
They certainly have. I wonder too, Jason, too, we talked about some of the indirect kicking and the poor kicking for goal. Now, obviously, there's the pressure's got something to do with that, but would the wind also have something to do with it here at the MCG
today?
I think
so. In particular, someone like Joel Bowden, we just saw there, kick it out in the full. He's kicked three out in the full, and he's one of the best kicks on the ground. Rory Hilton just missing on the opposite side of the body there. Here's a shot for goal. Now, you tell me that's not a behind. And it was classified as out in the ball. But you're right. Look, people that are normally tremendous kicks, look at the wobble on that one. It's just been a bit a combination of the wind and also the pressure has made kicking very, very difficult today.
Interesting to see if it improves in the second half. 8 points the margin if you've just joined us. The other player I think that's very interesting is Ray Hall. One of those players who's done some really great work, but probably a couple of occasions where his coach might have said, Ray, what are you doing?
Well, he gave away some free kicks early, but then he got himself involved. He got on the end of a great hand pass there from Jason Tawney and kicked a tremendous long goal. Set one up just a little bit after that. So he bounced back with a number of telling possessions.
But the Tigers have been winning it out of the centre, haven't they? And that's the name of the game here in this final this afternoon. And playing on at all costs. And players like Campbell with their deft little handballs and use of the ball are proving absolute winners.
I think that's what Danny Frawley gave as instructions to the team. He said, when we do get possession, let's move it at every cost. We don't want to give them time to readjust. Let's just shoot the ball forward and give our forwards a chance. And there was a great pass in there to Matthew Rogers.
So match stats at half-time, no major discrepancies. Perhaps ball in dispute, the marking, of course, 29-41, and also the handballs.
Yeah, just a little bit more of the ball, Richmond, but perhaps haven't transferred that into a margin on the scoreboard.
No, we have a contest, though, here at half-time in this knockout final. 8 points the margin. We'll take a break. Back with Paul Salmon.
This was Danny Frawley. When the half-time siren sounded, he was very quick to sprint out into the ground. Obviously just wanted to make a couple of points, fresh in his mind.
Yeah, just look, just while the players, before they come off and settle down and recover, just make a couple of quick points, tell them we're still in front, we've done the hard work, it's been a good first half, but we've got to back it up.
There's one of the legends, Bruce Doole, who's seen Craig Bradley equal his game's record of 356 today. Brandles will be hoping to pass it next week, but first up they've got to overcome Richmond. Let's go down to the boundary line. Aussie.
Yes, Andy, a terrific first half, especially for the Richmond Football Club. I suppose it was a crucial last few minutes, though. The only down point, I suppose, the fact that Richmond probably can't play a lot better. Carlton got a fair bit of lifting to do, and they're only 8 points down. So for me, I'm still sticking with Carlton, but it's been a terrific game so far.
Actually, that's a very good point, isn't it? There are a lot of players from Carlton that haven't picked up a lot of possessions. Darren Hulme is the leading possession winner with 12. Kuta has 11.
But who's to say that Richmond won't do the same job again in the second half, Sandy? Exactly, it's on between Broderick and Plunkett.
Duncan Kellaway, the leading tackler in the first half with 7. Hickmott, 4 for the Blues.
Second half underway. 8 points is the margin. Allen charges out of it. It's socket off the ground. Down towards the half forward line for the Tigers. McKay misses Richardson. Richo, the athlete, dashes through and gives it to Bowden. Bowden goes up towards Hilton. Couldn't quite take the mark. Spilled free at the bottom of the pack. McKay's hand pass partly smothered. Fletcher's in all sorts of trouble. It's thrown out the back door. A lightning start for Bradley. Bradley wants Koutoufides. He can't get clear. He's buffeted from pillar to post, but they've maintained possession. Over the top goes Prendergast. Prendergast gives it to Plunkett. Little Jimmy goes into the forward line. Whitnall needs a kind bounce. Not only that, he needs assistance. He hasn't got it at the moment. He gives a little ground. Favola's under pressure. Tumbles a left foot that only goes metres. Gasper is gang tackled. Drops the footy. Then just paddles it wide. That was clever. Tigers will get out of trouble. Finally, a little bit of respite. Chaffee takes a bounce. He has a look downfield. Spears it in towards the half forward line. Belted clear by Mansfield. Drops down in front to Sziller. Sziller gets the hand pass off to Broderick. He eludes one tackle. Gets it away to Cameron. Leon can go all the way. 55 out. Coming back. What a start by the Tigers.
That is absolutely brilliant play, isn't it? If there's any question mark as to whether the Tigers could back up their effort in the first half, just the opening couple of minutes here in the second half. Matthew Richardson, his attack on the ball a few moments ago was brilliant. And this time, just working it from down back, a good chain of hand passes. Broderick just got through an Andrew McKay tackle, which you don't expect to see too often. And that's the man you want running by. Doesn't matter which foot he's kicking it with, Leon Cameron. He just did it. He could have had a bounce and run closer. Didn't need to. From 50 unloaded. Perfect start for the Tigers. Oh, good bump that. Look at that.
Matthew Richardson there.
Doing it at both ends, Matthew Richardson, defensively as well.
So the first goal in the second half, Brendan Gale caught, missed Beaumont. Oh, too high, that tackle by Sziller on Hickmott. And Hickmott will take the free kick. Looking to get moving quickly, Adrian Hickmott. Blues trail by 14 points.
Great kick.
Kick is a beauty. Favola has provided the lead, and he was honoured with a beautiful pass from Adrian Hickmott. 150 gamer from last couple of weeks ago, Adrian Hickmott, but we've got Brendan Favola going short, player on his own. How could Camparelli, who's a brilliant kick of the football, get loose 45 metres from goal?
Tell you what, he got caught, matched up with Brendan Gale out in the flank there. And once Gale thought that Favola was going to go back and have a shot, he thought, as the big man, I've got to get down on the goal line. But unfortunately, he needed to call a teammate over to pick up Scott Camparelli.
Camparelli will kick from perhaps a little closer than 45. He'll have to kick the ball at least that distance to score. He sets it up and it drifts right away with the breeze, doesn't even score.
In the end, I'm not sure there was any great advantage in the kick because it was only about 5 metres closer, and Favola's a very long kick anyway from directly in front, so perhaps should have backed himself.
This is Holland with the football. Goes a little too far.
Oh,
Koutoufides is marked. Koutoufides to play on. Gee, puts the Tigers under pressure here. Whitnall gets back. Big punch by Andrew Kellaway. Didn't he do well, because he must have sensed a certain amount of urgency there, and he punched it clear for a boundary throw-in.
Yeah, it's a tremendous, tremendous spoil from Andrew Kellaway. Really getting Ben Holland out of jail. It was his poor kick that put them under the pump, and it was his man that would have marked it.
Right forward pocket for the Blues. Ben Holland down the line. Doesn't get the ball over. Camparelli gets back. Well shepherded by Whitnall. Some space for Scott Camparelli. Kicks the ball to the goal square. Mark taken back there by one of the goal kickers for Richmond so far in this game. And it was a beauty. Ray Hall has marked on the last line.
Possession number 10 for Ray Hall.
Kicks the ball high in the air. Koutoufides punches it back towards the 50-metre line for the Blues. Only to see it bundle over for a boundary throw-in.
Well, the problem with the last couple of forays out of defence for the Tigers is both times they've kicked it up in the air straight to Koutoufides. He's marked one, he's punched the other back forward.
Porter Houlihan, Hotton and Christou on the bench for Carlton to start this second half. at the back. Campbell gets a hurried high kick up towards centre wing. Fletcher, Hilton, McKay, Broderick, and it's McKay.
Kuta going back to the goal square.
Plunkett's away.
Kuta.
Plunkett from 75. Koutoufides got to beat a couple. Gasper's in front, smashed again towards the boundary line. Whitnall is there, can't keep it in play, and there'll be a throw-in in the right forward pocket for Carlton.
And that's where Brendan Gale is so good at getting a kick behind play. Rather than a one-on-one contest between Koutoufides and Gasper, he was there to come over the top with the big thump towards the boundary.
Benny Gale. Whitnall, he puts it straight down the throat of Campbell. Gets a call from Bowden. Kick under pressure, he puts it out on the full. And he's going to get another chance.
Gets an earful for his trouble from Adrian Hickmott as well. Joel Bowden after kicking out on the full.
Lappin, tucked right on the boundary line.
Sandy, I went out the back of the commentary box at half-time. It is very blustery.
Across the square, Koutoufides was there. Couldn't take the mark. Kellaway, Gasper and co. They tied out once again this Richmond defence. Mansfield leads in the race on centre wing. Gains probably 35, 40 metres and he pokes it towards Allen. He's got a shrug one and he does it pretty well. Gives it off to Freeborn. Freeborn centering ball, that's better, in towards half forward. Lapping together, but he lost it. Tigers again to clear. Gale's got to be quick. Benny goes wide to the outer side. Broderick might get there in time. He won't. It's out on the full.
Blues have got to capitalise. They've had a fair amount of play here and they have yet to score a goal in this turn.
Short pass is okay. Beaumont. He's a left footer. He's tucked on the boundary line. But this is his side of the ground.
Well, that's the only thing he's got going for him, the fact that he is a left footer. But most players have found it very difficult from this pocket. And in fact, I don't think we've seen one kicked from any sort of angle in this pocket today thus far.
Kicking from just on 49 metres. Swings it in, but again, it goes across the face of goal. Another behind. So Richmond getting the early blood in the third quarter with Leon Cameron kicking his first goal, and the Blues still looking for their first in this second half.
The kick goes out wide where it really did sit up beautifully for Matthew Allen, and when the Tigers looked as though they were going to clear their defensive part of the ground, it's going to go bouncing back in the form of Darren Hulme. He's quite prepared to go short. That's a free kick, isn't it, to Lappin? He was going to take
that.
The mark, and he has just been absolutely crunched in the midriff.
Well, the umpire has signalled a push. Now, you're entitled to push an opponent in the side. It's only in the back you're not allowed to push him. Does he come in from the side? I think he does. I think that's
a bit of a bonus, you think, for the Blues?
Oh, it's a toss of the coin. Toss of the coin decision. But again, Hall, gee, doesn't he love getting involved in it? Prendergast, Koutoufides, doesn't matter who. He's not going to take a backward step.
So we're watching Matthew Lappin shoot for goal. It goes across the face. Mark is taken by the protagonist, Ray Hall.
Certainly adds a bit of spice. There's Ray Hall, the 20-year-old from Woi Woi. Towards centre wing, smashed away from Kellaway, but the Tigers have the crummers and they go up towards Richo. He'll go again, he's got to go again. So does Silvani. Hand pass out wide towards Hulme. Had it, lost it, he's got to go back and get it. Bradley in for the late assist. Bounces a bad one for Allen, an absolutely cool one. Plunkett gives him support, just gets his kick away in time. Towards the 50 once more. Bowden comes crashing in over the top. Chaffee keeps his cool. Hall is there once again. Little chip is going to be okay. And Campbell shows courage.
Yep. Good courage, that one. He knew he was going to get hit, but he protected the ball.
Rogers in the middle of the ground to the big guns. Oh, the mark has been taken at the back. Not paid to Ottens.
Didn't take it.
Cameron left it behind. McKay steadies now from half back in towards Plunkett. He's got Freeborn. Maybe a chance for Carlton to mount something here. Freeborn gives it away to the left foot of Allen. Allen chips, but he chips a little too far in front. Nice bounce for Koutoufides, but he's a long way out and smothered by Hall. He's the man of the moment, Ray Hall. Back to Koutoufides, overruns it. Pressure from Hall, was there holding. Kellaway caught, ripped into the ground.
Oh, it's a free kick, Jason, don't worry about that.
Could have gone either way.
Don't argue, boys, for Vola to Freeborn.
Kick a goal!
He can go from 45.
Miss.
And he misses to the left.
Isn't it amazing? It's started again. A number of turnovers, poor kicks, fumbles, just mishandling of the ball. That one was a point, but we've seen 11 times the ball's been kicked out in the full. 8 by Richmond, 3 by Carlton. Tommy, 6 of those have been shots for goal.
Sandy, Tommy Hafey was very critical. He just said this is one of the worst games he's ever seen. And he wasn't prepared to take into account the blustery conditions. He just said that they're just playing shocking footy. And the first, 10 minutes of this term, there's been quite a lot of errors made. I'm prepared to give them a little bit of benefit of the doubt because it is difficult down there at ground level. Campbell controlling the football, goes out wide to Brendan Gale. He's at left half back for the Tigers, looking maybe to hang on to it. Sziller was there, but he got it back to Campbell. Campbell into the middle, have got a chance here. Ray Hall runs past the runner. That was Dale Waitman. He encouraged, but the kick drops short, and it's chopped off by Koutoufides. Now the Blues can go down the ground here. Look at Whitnall on his own! On his own! 15 metres in the clear! Amazing, isn't it? You go down the ground, you look as though you've got total control. A slight error back here for Koutoufides, and all of a sudden it's back in the hands of the Blue.
Turnovers kill you. They just dead set kill you. They had plenty of time in the middle of the ground. Ray Hall went forward, but in the end, Kuta stood tall, moved the ball on quickly, and Lance Whitnall. He's the best at finding space. He's had a very, very quiet day. Only the 6 possessions, hasn't registered a score at this stage. But this is the one they want.
Plunkett has come off the ground, replaced by Ryan Houlihan, but the stage is set here for Lance Whitnall. It's a very low scoring game, just 12 goals kicked in a half plus 11 minutes of the third term. Whitnall going for goal. Lance Whitnall has missed, and missed by a reasonable margin.
Yeah, there are a lot of them confused by the breeze, and I think if there's any doubt when you're wondering which way it's going to go, you just kick it direct, kick through the ball, don't give away the goals, and just hope that you strike the ball cleanly enough to keep it on its desired path.
Back to an 11-point ball game. Halfway through this third quarter. Hall has been effective. A terroriser. He goes short and he tests Stephen Sziller. Hand pass is going to be okay and he works the 1-2. Sziller comes through the middle. The Tigers go to Gaspar. Marks in front of Hickmont. Gives it back once more. They look good as they go inside 50. Where's the tall timber? Odds was at the back. Could have been fringed. McKay plays on in front of the pack and defends back towards centre wing. Good strong mark taken and it's given to Camporelli and it came from Prendergast.
Koutoufides.
He goes warm up towards Kuda. He's outmarked by his teammate this time. In Favola. Favola's 55 out. Again, he wobbles it towards the forward line. Beaumont is there, but he's going to be pressured by Gale. Gives it away quickly. Freeborn takes it. Tackle. Gets a snappy kick. Back to Lappin. Back again to Whitnall. Lance for goal. Oh. No, he goes the other side this time. Boy, they're peppering, but getting very little result.
I can't remember the last time we saw two of the better teams in the competition. We're just seeing the Koutoufides recovering from a knock, but two of the more skillful sides in the competition having so much trouble with conditions, pressure, whatever, just making what looked to be simple errors, but obviously the pressure's telling, and it might be the one that can produce a few more skillful moments in this game that'll do enough to win.
4 points to Carlton in this term. The Tigers, though, more importantly, have that one goal. This is Silvani over the other side. He's away now to Allen. Sun proving a problem. Rogers gives chase. He gives it away to Bradley.
Look in the pocket, Houlihan.
Bradley, settle down, Robbo. Houlihan is 55 out. He can keep going. He spears a worm-burning pass into the pocket. Maybe the wrong option.
Poor option. Poor option, that one. Trying to force a low dart into the pocket right on the boundary line. It would have been a near impossible kick anyway, even if the mark had been taken by Beaumont. Freeborn is the man that has now gone on to Wayne Campbell to do the job and has done a pretty good one, although Campbell's starting to get more of it this quarter.
Look at that stat. 12-4.
But they haven't put the goals on the board. That's the problem.
To the half-back line. Allen is lurking. He'll get there late, but he'll get there. Can't pick it up. Fit of the fumbles. Knights draws it back in. Got a free kick.
Got
a
kick. Interesting battle, that one. Knights with 9 possessions. Bradley with just the 11 possessions.
Probably Bradley is a little bit more athletic, got more agility than Matty Allen. I didn't quite see what that free kick was all about.
It was a lucky one, Robbo.
Favola goes back and leaves his man at ground level. Duncan Kellaway, the mongrel kick. Oh.
And you take them when you can get them. There's nothing in the rule book that says the ball has to spin in any particular fashion when it goes through, but that one didn't spin at all. That was a floater. An absolute floater. Duncan Kellaway just roved it beautifully. You could see which way the pack was facing. That was the way the ball was always going to come. Look at the trajectory on that. But it floated through and a crucial one for the Tigers.
A defining moment in the career of Duncan Kellaway. He's kicked his 11th career goal and he'll be talking about it to his grandchildren as they go out of the middle up towards the half forward line. Hall gets a bad bounce. Kellaway was there once again, couldn't take it. Here's Bradley out of the middle, tripped, gets up, puts it onto the left foot in towards Whitnall.
Got to kick a goal.
He's not confident. He thought about Lappin. He's 50 out. He's going to be kicking from probably 54, Robbo.
Well, if he hits it, it can get the distance.
Again, not very pretty. Away to the left.
They've just had so much of the play, Carl. They had it at the end of the second quarter. They've had it at the beginning of the third quarter, the first half of this third quarter. But they just they cannot translate possession into goals. And that's been a huge problem for them, and that's why they're behind by 15 points and struggling.
And yet they've had 15 effective scoring shots each. 15 points, as Jason said, is the margin. Towards the half back line. Knights has to go again over Koutoufides.
Kudu's grabbing his knee too. He's put the foot in to try and clear that ball, and I think he's hurt his right knee.
Good observations there, Richard. He came in from the side of the pack, didn't he? And
he's in a bit of pain.
Well, you speak of defining moments in a game. This could well be one. What an absolute tragedy.
Given his reaction, Sandy, you can just see it here. He comes in. See if it gets caught in. Oh, you could just see it look to.
Oh, there. Oh, dear.
Well, I hate to say it, but that's the sort of motion that way that you can do your anterior cruciate ligament.
Yeah, I was about to say, Jace, very similar to how I did mine.
Yep, it just got trapped under the body.
Yep.
That went across him. And you can just see him in obvious discomfort straight away, and you'd be a brave person to suggest he'll take any further part in this game, but more importantly, if they do manage to win the final series.
Daffy has come onto the ground while all that was happening.
And the other interesting thing, when a player goes off on the stretcher, Robbo, it's what impact it has on both teams. There's a lengthy stoppage in play. Both teams get together, as they have done in groups, to talk about it. The Blues, will it inspire them, or will Richmond run over the top of them?
Well, they've shown in the past, Carlton, that in the face of adversity, they can come through. But this is a great tragedy, not only for the club, but more particularly for Anthony Koutoufides.
Just have a look when he puts the leg down and it just goes sideways underneath the body of Matthew Knights. It's just one of those unfortunate incidents. You can't prevent it. You're just attacking the ball. But let's just hope, fingers crossed, that it's not the anterior cruciate. And a much less severe knee injury for Anthony Koutoufides.
The man has been averaging over 30 possessions for the last month.
Amazing, isn't it? The opportunity for his old, very good friend, Ange Christou. But he wouldn't like that side at all, Ange Christou. That's Anthony Koutoufides leaving the ground. The Blues kicked the first 2 points in this game. Richmond have led from then on. After they got the front, the Tigers with, I think, three scrounged behinds, if you'd call it that. They've led from probably about, 7 or 8 minutes into the first turn.
And the closest that Carlton has got has been 8 points.
Well, both runners having plenty to say to their charges. Obviously, the coach has taken this opportunity to get a few messages out. Just reconfirm a few of the tactics and matchups.
Well, Carlton has to reorganise itself. Does it also put a little bit of pressure on Richmond too to work out now what's going on, and they have to do a little bit of changing as well?
Well, they do, and it's interesting to see Nick Daffy is out on the field for Richmond, so he's obviously one that's come on.
He came on while all that was happening,
yeah.
And
yeah.
Hilton left the ground. But is this the sort of you know, when a really good player in the opposition leaves the field, do they sense that there might be an opportunity to release Daffy?
You'd think so, definitely. Mind you, Duncan Kellaway, who's been doing the job on Koutoufides. Koutoufides, 15 possessions, 2 goals, been pretty good. Slow start. Duncan Kellaway has had 11 possessions and kicked a goal himself. What role does he take now? Who does he go on to? Or does he just drop back into defence?
Danny Frawley has also yet to release David Burt for a run today. So players resume their positions as Koutoufides, I think, tries to explain just what has happened and what he's feeling at the moment. Must be absolute despair. His side is down by 15 points and he is out of the game. But the action is set to continue. The ball is on the left half forward flank. Richmond leads by 15 points. Carlton desperately need a score. It's been all behind so far for the Blues in this third term.
Prendergast off and hot and on for the Blues.
Plunkett, Kellaway and co. They pile on it like a stack of pikelets. And there'll be a bounce. Five behind to Carlton in this quarter. Hickmott, round the body he goes. Flicks it up towards the half forward line. Gale applies an excellent tackle on Beaumont. He asks the question, but again, we'll have another bounce.
You mentioned the five behind, Sandy. They're just kicking themselves out of it at the moment, the Blues. They kicked a couple late in the second quarter to get back in the game. They need to do it again now.
So the bounce of the ball at left half forward. Plunkett tries to take it. Bradley plays for the free kick and gets it. Didn't have the ball. Matthew Knight's a little stiff, but the letter of the law. There's a bit of a dust-up in the crowd down in front of us here, and most fans are looking back, not watching the football as Bradley takes possession. 12 touches for Craig Bradley in his...
Will he try and run around him, Robert?
Games record-equaling performance for the Blues. Whitnall couldn't take the mark. The spillage is at half-foot. Freeborn has taken it, and Freeborn should kick. A behind, and he doesn't even do that. Unbelievable scenes here in the first 20 minutes of this term. That's
Nick Daffy's already in
strife with the wrist.
It looks like he's done his wrist. He was barely on for a couple of minutes, hadn't had a possession the first couple of contests, and he looks in real strife.
Bowden goes for the safety of the boundary line for Vola there with Jason Tawney.
Well, he's not just holding the wrist, he was also up around the shoulder. So perhaps he's done a shoulder. You just see him backing in there, and it's, he has landed flush on his right shoulder, or the left shoulder on the ground, the body on the right shoulder.
Bradley goes for Freeborn, and Freeborn, at his third opportunity, he's kicked the goal for the Blues they were looking for.
Yeah, they're anxiously looking.
So after a succession of behinds, six, in fact, before they got their sixth goal, and that was kicked by Scott Freeborn at the 23-minute mark of the term.
Even that one, I mean, it's such a desperately needed goal for the Blues. It doesn't come off the boot particularly well. It goes very high and very close to the right-hand goalpost. Should have been a lot simpler for that. And they all had to wait for the decision.
So Scotty Freeborn gets the drought breaker.
And Sandy, I'll try and keep you up to date with Nick Daffy. They've taken him straight up the race in the rooms. Doesn't look good.
Bad news for Nick, who's probably spent a couple of minutes on the ground.
We keep expecting Carlton to charge at Richmond with so much possession, but to the Tigers' credit, they haven't stopped their endeavour, their tackling, their work rate, their desperation has been fantastic. They refuse to concede.
Well, they've got a quarter and 6.5 minutes to continue to pour it on. They've won themselves a preliminary final berth. It's not over yet. Cameron finds King. King to Bowden on the outer side. Marks in front of Beaumont. Goes on to the left foot, in towards the forward line. The diving attempt was there from Campbell. He picks himself up, handballs over the top. Manton will try and push towards the line. Ottens will keep it in. He almost threw it back into play. He did.
That's a scoop. He just scooped it. He needed to either clench the fist and punch it or slap it back, but the scoop was deemed to be a throw.
They've only been forward a couple of times and they've kicked two goals, Richmond, and nearly looked like it was going to be a third one there.
Manton to the half back line. Hotten in from the side.
See, I thought there was almost a terrific mark taken in there. A couple of the players asking the question. Looked like it was juggled with the one arm. Joel Bowden's asking the same question. He said, did you see what just happened then? Which game are you umpiring?
Beaumont beaten. The Tigers gain valuable metres and Broderick again sees it over for a throw-in.
Brendan Gale looks like he's making his way off for a spell and Matthew Rogers coming on to replace him.
So injuries taking their toll in this third quarter. Daffy off for the Tigers. Koutoufides out of the game with a recurring knee injury. Bowden, little toe poke, gathers no distance. Still on 50. Christou locks it up and forces a bounce.
Still 5.5 minutes left in the term, and I think you mentioned, Sandy, a moment or so ago that the closest the Blues have got since they led in the early minutes of the game was 8 points. It's a margin now of 9. Very important next goal in the context of the game. Matthew Knights was dispossessed. The kick goes forward, and the mark is taken at fullback by Silvani. Looked to play on, but obviously could not see any advantage in doing that. So has held the ball up and then kicked it into the middle, and Kellaway jumping in front of Matthew Lappin is strongly marked for the Tigers. He kicks into the pocket. It just goes past his teammates down there. Fletcher gets the little handball and then goes very wide. Good scramble there by Hickmott. Another good scramble by Hickmott. And in over the top went Beaumont. When Richmond looked with their feet on the ground, the Blues desperate to try and hold it up, and they succeeded with a boundary throw-in.
Both teams again missing targets and under no great pressure on those occasions.
So the boundary throw-in taking place about 80 metres around from the Richmond goal. Ottens not able to take the football with him. He was the ruckman at that boundary throw-in.
And Matthew Rogers had been on for 30 seconds to replace Brendan Gale. Comes straight back off and David Burke on.
This is Nick Daffy going down underneath Lance Whitnall. And the elbow, the shoulder.
Everything just got caught underneath, didn't it?
And there's a ruck contest close to centre wing. King and Bradley. Fletcher at the back.
Real shame for Nick Daffy. He's fought so hard, put off the knee operation. He's discovered some form in the VFL. Finally got the opportunity. Waited a long time to get on the ground, and then he's on a matter of seconds and off with what looks to be a serious arm injury.
Some famous names in the crowd, including David Cloak. Wonderful player.
Silvani's gotten on top of Richardson in this quarter the few times it's come forward, although the Tiger forwards have been starved of possession. He's done very well in the third quarter, Steve Silvani.
9 points in it. With Carlton to manage only 6 goals in almost three quarters of football, they're going to have to pour it on in the final term. Broderick's in trouble. Not before he's able to get the hand pass away. High ball goes in towards Richardson. Couldn't take the mark. Burke was there as well, and Burke will go again. Tries to push it further afield, and he does so now to Campbell. Campbell tucked on the line, bends it round, but well done on the last line of defence by Fletcher. Campbell,
10th position quarter, turn.
Gives it to Christou. Christou short, finding Hickmott. Hickmott through half back by Hulme. Hulme goes to the outer side and Plunkett. There's 3 minutes left in the quarter. Jimmy wants to go short again.
Great spoil, Ben Holland. Desperate spoil. They're the hardest ones to defend when the forward virtually has to dive to get the ball down low. But he lunged desperately with the right arm. That's a sensational spoil from Ben Holland.
Yep. Rogers back on for Duncan Kellaway as the ball is in dispute on centre wing. Lappin is wrapped up well by Jason Tawney. Jason Dunstall suggesting that it may have been a free kick against Matthew Lappin, but the umpire will bounce.
Thought it was a tremendous tackle. Didn't get any reward.
Matthew Lappin, there's the score. 9 points the margin. It got out to around about 22 points at one stage in the second term. And the Blues have hung in there. Tigers not able to break away. Camporelli, Bowden, chopped off by McKay. It goes into the forward half for the Blues. Marking contest, punched away by the Richmond defence there in Leon Cameron, was it, I think. And he finds the result will be a boundary throw-in. The ball is at right half forward for the Blues, and we've got 2 minutes left in the term. They were building at the end of the second term, and they're building at the end of the third. They were unsuccessful in their quest in the second quarter. Well, the next couple of minutes will show. Matthew Knights kicks it back. No mark taken. Hulme trying to rush it forward. Chance for Camporelli.
gets the ball to Christou. He in turn to Freeborn, who was a goal kicker for the Blues in this term. He gets good distance with the kick. It goes all the way.
Oh, great
mark by Ottens. He was out of position, but he threw the arms in the air and successfully dragged it in.
That's what separates average big men from the great big men.
Short
kick
is all right.
And give the defenders a chop out, Robbo, and that was just a tremendous effort.
Here's Chaffee going towards Gasper, who's almost in the middle. He's away. He's got players streaming down the ground. Campbell, the juggler, gives it away quickly towards Cameron, who flicks it inside 50 once again. Richardson on the half volley, had it and lost it, but King's there to assist him. Clinton King gives it away to Tivendale. Tivendale quickly to Cameron. Cameron long in towards full forward. Tigers have the charge. Yes!
Oh!
Sziller! Stephen Sziller will go back and kick the goal to extend the Tigers' lead close to siren time.
And I'll tell you what, I think it was Scott Camporelli as they're coming down. He just got lost. He got lost looking at his opponent. He forgot to look at the ball. And Stephen Sziller probably could have got the free kick if he didn't take the mark at the second attempt, but just got caught. Not a thing you'd have to go up in the contest.
Don't want to put the moz on him. He's kicked no goals and six behinds for the season. Stephen, 20 metres out. Can he break the drought?
He can.
Yes, he can. This time it's the Tigers taking advantage of time on.
Well, they have outscored the Blues in this third quarter totally against the run of play. They've had probably 70% of possession. And they've kicked three goals to just the one. And honestly, with the amount of possession there, the Blues should be in front.
What a bonus with just 29 seconds remaining in the quarter. Carlton are going to have to produce something now in this final term as Campbell goes to Broderick.
Well, this could quite possibly be the last kick of the quarter. If he was out, he's going to go short.
Broderick does go short. Mark not taken. The bump ball, play on. Ottens does. He gets caught from behind. Lose it to McKay. McKay towards Bradley. Bradley in turn loses. There's been a whistle, a free kick to Carlton. It matters not. It is three-quarter time. And Paul Broderick, the 261-game veteran from Camperdown in the Western District, decided to go short. Didn't get his chance. And the Tigers go in at three-quarter time. But they lead by 15 points, and that was the margin at quarter time.
They were probably a metre off that pass, actually putting them away, the Tigers. The goal there could have nearly have sewn it up.
Three-quarter time, Richmond at 9-7-61. Leading Carlton, 6-10-46. Well, the third quarter certainly took its toll from Carlton's point of view. The tragedy to see Koutoufides. You can see him grimacing there. He knows that he has a severe knee problem. And Nick Daffy, who's fought so hard to come back into this Tiger lineup, spent only minutes out on the ground before he was crunched. Can Carlton catch Richmond? That's the big question. The Tigers booted three straight in that third term. Carlton sadly off target, 1-5. At three-quarter time, it is 9-7-6-10. Multiple goal kickers. Well, for the Tigers, it is only Brad Ottens. And for Carlton, their principal scorers, Hulme and Koutoufides, both have two. The margin going into the final quarter is 15 points. The latest news from the Telestrator comes from Paul Salmon.
Well, yeah, Blues been having trouble finding some clear avenues to go on. The Tigers flooding back is one of the prime examples. Look at this situation early in that quarter. A lot of numbers back. It's really forcing the Blues to skirt around the 50 on the odd occasion. And having trouble finding those avenues to go are the Blues. The only options are in short around the peripheral of the 50. And the Tigers are doing a good job working hard in defence and then working hard with aggressive running through the midfield.
Tigers are breaking up. Let's go down to the boundary line. Aussie, you've got John Worsfold with you.
Yeah, thanks for joining us, John. A few crucial misses early in that third quarter. A lot of work to do for the boys.
Yeah, it is. You know, we expended a lot of energy for no result on the scoreboard that quarter. So, yeah, we've got a lot of work to do now.
And just quickly, have you heard how Cooter is?
Haven't heard, no, but obviously not that happy about it.
Thanks, mate. Good luck.
Thanks.
The question is, can they make up the margin? They've taken three quarters to boot six goals.
And Koutoufides had kicked two of those, Sandy.
Yeah. A huge roar as the final quarter gets underway.
Must get the first goal of the term, the Blues.
The final quarter for one of these two sides. Carlton kicking to the right. The Tigers to the left, and it's King who gets the first kick for the Tigers. Down towards Richardson. Couldn't take the mark. Silvani will defend. Tivendale gives chase. Silvani to the outer side, and Houlihan finds his mark. He'll look towards Hickmott up on the half forward line. Sneaks clear and marks in front of Tawney. And Kellaway it is. Hickmott then. Between centre wing and half forward, goes close to the boundary line, goes too close on the wrong side. Puts it out on the full. Holland.
He's a good young player, isn't he, Ben Holland?
Done a tremendous job on Lance Whitnall today. Whitnall just the nine possessions and three behind.
Very disciplined.
He's tucked in the back pocket.
Well, courageous.
And he comes across the face of goal. It was courageous, but it was effective. They're clear now towards centre wing. And Darren Gasper taking the pass. Gasper looks up towards the half forward line. The sun is a bit of a problem. Richardson gets a bad bounce. Mansfield gets a good one. Gives it across to McKay. McKay looks towards right half forward. Goes over Gasper. Allen was forced to spoil at the back. No one at home there. Tigers have a chance through Gasper once more. Takes the hammer. Bang! Put his teammate under a ton of pressure. Campbell gives it out to Gasper. He goes wider to Gale. Gale gives it back towards Cameron. Cameron will chip towards centre wing. Hickman almost runs into his own man in Christou, and finally Campbell is taken over the line by Ann.
Well, they have to manufacture something quickly, Carlton, because it just results in a bit of an arm wrestle. They've got to outscore Richmond by three goals to get in front, and it's going to be a tremendous task because the Tigers have fought gallantly so far. Awkward bounce at half forward. To say that was awkward, gee, it went all the way through to Matthew Richardson. He shrugged the tackle from Christou, then kicks it across the line in front. Carlton's best player today, in my opinion, Andrew McKay. He has played a terrific game at halfback. Goes out wide where Houlihan is on his own. He's able to gather. And then with the left, kicks it in the direction of Whitnall. Both players fall over, Whitnall and Ben Holland. It comes to Tawney. He shrugs the tackle. He runs into a bit of trouble. Able to get the hand pass away. Well done by the Tigers. They were there in numbers. It finished with Sziller. Sziller goes for the goal square. It's a bit of an up and under. Silvani is back there. He can't quite take the mark, but he's able to break away. And he kicks it out very wide. Now the Blues have got to mount something here. Manton feeds the handball to Houlihan. Houlihan off the side of his boot. That's a little too clever when you trail by nearly three goals. The chance now for Richmond. Bowden gets the ball into the middle where Tivendale takes it and kicks it out wide. And they keep possession through Andrew Kellaway. He went one way, then the other, then back onto the left, kicking it in towards half forward. Mansfield missed it completely. Back in the direction of Plunkett. King gets the awkward kick off the ground. Hickmott has a chance. He backs out of trouble. Got the handball away. Camporelli from halfback. Goes very short. Marker's taken by Lappin. A couple of their players that were big in previous weeks. Lappin, Houlihan, etc. Just have to get into the game and kick goals for the Blues if they're to win. Brendan Gale at halfback. Now young Holland to Andrew Kellaway. A lovely hand pass. Tawney, King and Richmond have possession of the ball in the middle through Joel Bowden.
And they've got players streaming down the ground. One of them is Leon Cameron, goes on to the left foot. It's a high ball in towards the pocket. No mark taken. Who's going to be first to recover? A whistle.
Free kick. He's paid it for over the shoulder. It looked to be a genuine attempt to mark the ball from Matthew Rogers.
Rogers can't believe it. Lappin will play on. Chipping towards Hickmott, who marks in front of Kellaway. Thought about giving it to McKay, who was going past. Houlihan.
Good tackle.
Pendergast loses it. Camporelli scratching and clawing with Sziller.
Gee, Ray Hall's tackle on Prendergast was a superb one. And I think he's hit his head on the turf as he got driven in. He had the arms pinned and he is very groggy. I think the tackle was that good. It locked both arms. He then slammed the head of Prendergast into the turf. Have a look at this. He wraps up both arms, slings him to the turf. Oh, and the head gets a fearful battering on the deck. This will be a great shot of it. He got one high there, I think, and then, oh, the head bounced on the turf.
Well,
He is going to be a very crook boy. He's not good at all.
He's not sure where he's at the moment.
Cotton has gone onto the ground for Prendergast.
15 points the margin. The bounce goes straight over. Now, I think Brian Sheehan might take it back and have another crack at it.
Very embarrassing if you did it twice in a row, wouldn't it, Sandy? You'd pray that you get a good bounce away now.
And he has. Gale flicking it over the back, just delaying the inevitable, maybe.
It's amazing. At no stage today has it developed into any sort of free-flowing contest. It's just been a last-man-standing affair. And at the moment, they're running out of a few, the Blues. Richo, copped it right in the mush.
From the throw-in, Plunkett couldn't take it, neither could Hulme. Hickmont, body over the ball, Camporelli, Campbell in, caught by Hulme. That's an excellent tackle. He's locked up and going nowhere.
There has been no quarter given from the very first bounce today, and I think Danny Frawley would be absolutely thrilled with the desperation and commitment from his players today.
And Sandy, just quickly, a couple of injury updates. I was speaking to one of the Carlton officials. They're hoping that it's only a medial with Kuta. Let's hope that. And Nick Daffley, it's a shoulder, not an elbow.
And Burke coming back out onto the ground. Thank you, Richard Osborne, as Hulme dashes clear. He gives it to Ange Christou, who woofs it up towards the 50, but it'll be chopped off again by Cameron. Disposal has been questionable. Cameron is very good.
18 possessions.
Tivendale on centre wing. 18, is it?
He's an architect, too, Leo Cameron.
Tivendale spearing it into the middle, and Campbell cruises through the centre, looks inside 50. They're trying to bury them here, but Richardson was three deep.
Got to take a few risks.
McKay to Hulme. McKay still running, but look out, you may get caught. There's tiredness starting to show now as Hickmont comes towards centre wing. His kick is ill-directed, but the fortune favours Fletcher because Bowden slipped at the crucial stage. They need a goal from this challenge. Fletcher goes to the forward line. Whitnall comes over the top, tries to push it further forward. Knights is there and he gives it away. Oh. Take it to the line, on the ball.
David Burke, I think.
He's only just been on.
He's just come on
to replace Mark Chappie.
I think it's his first touch, isn't it?
It is. He won't be happy with it, with the outcome, unfortunately. Look, he was in the right position. He just needed to go with the hands rather than the boot in that situation.
Gee whiz, this has got to be the most impossible kick of the day, doesn't it?
Well, it's a big day for him, and he's the sort of player that could mastermind something from here.
Here he is. He's equaling the Flying Doormats games record.
We'll call him the Professor if he gets this.
There's the Professor.
This looks good.
There's the Professor. Oh, just missed.
One behind.
Gee, he gave it a ride, didn't he?
Just how to work out, you know, which way the breeze was going to take the ball. I mean, it was a terrific effort by Craig Bradley. Just a behind, though. They've kicked since half-time. They've kicked one goal, six, and Richmond have added three straight. Leon Cameron. Margin is 14 points in favour of Richmond. Leon Cameron to bring the ball back for the Tigers. Blustery conditions have prevailed all day. Cameron eventually goes short into the pocket where Knights is only about 15 metres away. Knights with the ball goes short to Cameron. Gee, it's a fairly long time to go to be playing this sort of game, isn't it? I suppose if you've got the ball, the opposition have got to get it off you to have the opportunity to score. There's 14 minutes left in the term. The margin is 14 points in favour of Richmond with Campbell controlling play at the moment. Goes short into the centre. Bradley gets back, but he can't stop Ben Holland from marking. He feeds it off to Tawney. That kick was a little too long. Whitnall gets back. Hilton dispossessed. Chance for McKay. Little toe poke. May have been important because it's kept the ball in dispute. In goes McKay again on Gasper. Ottens, well done. Camporelli tries to get the ball clear. He's reasonably well locked up. And the umpire will bounce.
Mark Chaffee back on, going down back. David Burke, unfortunately, after his little mistake up forward or down back for the Tigers, he's back off.
Gasper got a whack in the head there in that little infringement.
Don't forget, all your finals action comes your way on I7 if you want to log on and check it. Here's Gasper, Manton to chop it off. Lee Matthews is here today, Jason. What do you think he'd be thinking at the moment?
Well, he would be rapt that these two sides have just attacked each other. He would love the fact that they'll be sore and sorry.
And I don't think he's probably seen anything that would frighten him at this stage, Sandy.
Andrew Kellaway. Gee, there was a chance there for the Blues. Camporelli had broke, but Mansfield's kick was not long enough.
Tries to make amends. Here's Sziller. Stephen Sziller got to come back. Way back to centre wing.
Gee, I'm impressed with this fella.
He's played a very big game for them.
What are his stats?
We all expected Gasper to line up on the Whitnall, but he's the man that's done the job.
They're
and in the end,
big.
He's had 12 touches, but
he's done
really,
the job, though, hasn't
he's
he?
He's chopped Whitnall out of the game.
Yeah. Holland, forward of centre. Long kick into a big pack, and Ottens is amongst the pack, but he couldn't take the mark. Hickmott claimed. He gives it off to Christou, who kicks back towards centre wing. It's wide, too wide for the bowler.
See, the point here is 10 minutes, nearly 11 minutes have elapsed. The Blues are still to kick their seventh goal,
yeah,
which would be their first for the term.
Well, they'd have won behind. Exactly
King
right.
King and Jim Plunkett now going head-to-head.
Gale.
That's Silvani in trouble behind
Fletcher.
Play too.
Bradley. Keep an eye on Silvani.
He's limping, yep.
Bowden in towards the middle. Oh, here's trouble. Kellaway. Looks towards the half-forward line. McKay couldn't quite on the half-volley. He's going to have it stolen by Hilton, but beautifully claimed by Christou. McKay does the tidying up. He's got some space now with Fletcher on the outer side. He's got a loose man further down the ground, and he's got to use him, and he does. Beaumont, the left-footer on right half-forward.
He's got to hold it up.
He's got nothing down in the forward line. It's all yellow and black.
Hotton's calling it long, but he's got two tools on him.
Eventually he does head in that direction. Hume will do the roving work. The Tigers get it through Gasper. Give it away once more. Campbell, Gasper, Knights cruises through the half back line. Maybe they can set up something now. Bowden looks towards the centre wing. It's wide and it's low and it's slapped away by Whitnall. Plunkett was his target, but he won't find him. Rogers sees it to the line. Plunkett's been on and off the bench today as we see a hobbling Silvani.
Got to go to the forward line, I think, by the look of it.
Yeah, he looks like he's rolled the ankle.
Crowd today of 83,323.
Boundary throw in on centre wing. Campbell takes possession of the ball. Umpires found a free kick. Might have been shepherding against the Richmond player, Matthew Allen. Gives it to Bradley. Bradley goes straight towards half forward. Must take a mark. Hotton was there, but it's gathered by Brendan Gale. Gives away a little bit of ground. It was a good hand pass, wasn't it, to Tawney? Tawney off the side of his boot did it well and found Cameron away from Hickmott. Cameron
Robert,
to Tivendale.
Sorry, boys. Silvani is coming off. He can't run at all.
Tivendale out wide. And all of a sudden,
Glenn Manton's
the tide has turned, hasn't it? Yes, yeah, Silvani leaps off the ground. Freeborn comes on and Richardson significantly takes a mark when he's been brilliantly held by Silvani for half the game. Kicks in towards the forward pocket area. Up over the top was Ottens with one hand. Christou on Tivendale. Still there Hilton, he keeps it alive, kicks it back to the goal front. Back there for the Blues is Mansfield. Looks to give away the hand pass to the far side of the ground. Plunkett has got to carry it. He will share it with Houlihan. Out wide, they get outside their defensive 50. He's being encouraged to move it now in towards the middle. An emphatic kick is landed in the hands of Hickmott. Houlihan runs on, and Hickmott may honour him, but he drops it in short, and Gasper. Haven't they made some errors with their kicking abilities, particularly in the early part of this last term?
Yeah, foot skills have been pretty ordinary for most of the game, in actual fact. Both sides have suffered at various times, but certainly the Blues, with so much possession in the second half, have missed far too many targets to come back and win the game. Richardson calling for it.
Chaffee's on his own in the middle.
They've only made up the one behind since three-quarter time. 14 points the margin. Richardson couldn't take it, but he finishes up with it. He wobbles a little one down towards the right half forward. Bradley intercepts, pops it over the top. Who's home? Jimmy Plunkett gets caught. Christou tries to steal it. He's tackled by Tivendale, and it's a ripper.
Andrew Kellaway was great. A couple of tackles in there from him. The one on Plunkett was brilliant. And then he followed up. And Wayne Brittain would be wondering what he could do to steal a goal at this stage.
Rogers trying a little bit of disguising work so that he can stay on the ground. Because of the blood war.
Kicking in danger there.
Beaumont.
To the favour of Beaumont.
He's got it on half back. There's got to be some urgency in Carlton now. Allen to the half-forward line, but to Richmond's credit, they're not allowing them. that urgency. The pressure has been intense. Cameron gets a call out wide from Gale. Benny's been all right too. Don't worry about that. Gale from the back pocket comes back towards centre wing. Kicks a little off skew on this occasion. The juggler is Fletcher. Gets it at the third attempt at his disposal again. Lets him down. Holland came over the top, then retrieves it. Gives it back to Chaffee. He's in trouble. Has to give a little ground. Back to Gale again. Back to Chaffee. Where are they going? Back from where they started. That was Leon Cameron. So he decides to change tack. He ambles away, looks towards the middle, and what are you doing there? Straight down the throat of Houlihan, and there was no one within cooey.
They're getting possessions, but they're not getting a goal. Richmond aren't worried.
Allen, another one, in towards Lappin. Almost ironical cheers that...
took the ruckman to hit a target.
Found a target. Lappin gets a lead. Hickmont's his man, and he knocks in front of Gasper.
That is criminal there.
All of a sudden, you've got 7 or 8 minutes left in the game. They haven't looked like scoring a goal, Carlton, but if they get this one, they would get nervous, Richmond. They've led all day. They've done so much hard work. You can just see here. Oh, just copping a backhander.
16 minutes of the last quarter. Richmond haven't scored. The Blues have kicked a point.
Yes, time at the moment is not a factor.
They'd get very nervous if he kicks this.
My word. Hickmont from 40 metres out. Need not worry because he's ripped that away to the left. Porter's going to come back out onto the ground. And Carlton had yet another behind. 6-12. They've had 18 effective scoring shots to 16 and they trail.
There's absolutely no doubt whatsoever that Richmond deserved to win the game. They've done the hard work from the start. They've controlled the game. But you just keep thinking with such a narrow margin, it's only 13 points. If they get within almost within a kick, they finally got Matthew Rogers for the blood rule. With red stuffing coming out of the nose. If they get within a kick, gee, wouldn't there be a few final nervous minutes for Richmond? You can just see, I don't know that he intended to hit him high. He certainly intended to retard his progress, Andrew McKay.
Leon Cameron with the football to bring it back. I don't think we want to see a replay. But anyway... it may not matter, because if Richmond win this game, Carlton are out of the finals for the year 2001. Short kick by Sziller. Still they keep possession of the ball. Soaking up precious seconds. Down to 7 minutes left. They need to kick in excess of 2 goals, and they need, of course, while they're doing that, to keep Richmond goalless. They have possession of the ball.
I think they'd love to kick another goal themselves, Richmond, just to put the matter beyond doubt.
Tivendale runs through the line. Freeborn, the tackler, he's still got it. Got the ball to Sziller, sidesteps beautifully, goes out wide. Now it's important, a very important possession right here. Beaumont is out there, so is Chaffee. Gets it back to Campbell. Campbell's kick is a beauty, but not able to take the mark down there was Andrew Kellaway. A contest for, struggling there. Hulme goes crashing through. Got the handball close to the line, and it went over for a boundary throw in. Darren Hulme will get up.
Nothing wrong with his performance today, Robbo. Darren Hulme, 18 possessions, a couple of goals. He's worked tirelessly. You can see Stephen Silvani trying to get a little bit of movement back in. It looks like it might be the right ankle.
Yeah, definitely, Jake. They put an amazing amount of tape on that right ankle, hoping to get him back on the ground.
And if he can get back on, one would suggest that he'd go straight to the forward line, and they'll be just clamouring for him to scramble a goal. Plunk it to Bradley. Bradley goes to the forward 50. Oh! Great leap there, but the crumbs nearly gathered by Lappin. Dives on the football at the back. There was Gasper. He's taken the free kick, Lappin. And Whitnall has played on it. Whitnall has kicked the goal. The Blues within 7.
Now the nervous times will start for Tigers supporters and also for Danny Frawley and the match committee, I'm sure. Duncan Kellaway coming back onto the ground.
Was that a free kick to Lappin? When you dive on the ball, watch as he goes for the ball.
But the bloke goes on top of him, Robbo. I think you've got to keep your feet. He slides on top of him. You just can't afford to do that. And Whitnall finally kicks one straight.
This is the closest Carlton has been in the game since the start.
You get the feeling they don't deserve to be that close, Sandy.
7 points out of the middle. Jimmy Plunkett has it taken away. This will test the character of the Richmond Football Club now. Freeborn's over the top. He wants ball, but he doesn't get it.
One thing they've got to do, Richmond, is not forget the game plan. They've still got to move the ball forward when they can and not try and eat up the time. 5.5 minutes is too much to eat up as Stephen Silvani comes back on. He goes forward. And Ray Hall has played a tremendous game. We'll pick him up.
And Burke is off for the Tigers. Kellaway is back on. Richardson caught. He's gone.
Too long. Is that 50? Benefit of the doubt to Joel Bowden.
Gee, pretty good effort there by Beaumont.
Great tackle. Great tackle.
If and Richardson just gets away.
Oh, it's all over.
Beaumont from half back heads towards centre wing. Houlihan waiting down in front. Can't get a space though. Can't get clear. He'll have another crack at it. Could have been holding on. King gets a hand pass wide towards Cameron. He's still on centre wing. Tigers can't buy a goal in this final quarter. Richardson over the head of him. Back towards Houlihan again. Keeps it in play. Shepherding. No, he's caught. A second attempt by Duncan Kellaway. Christie comes in to assist. Now the Blues are away. Beaumont again. Up towards centre wing. Porter was at the back. Bradley was in front. And it's smashed over the line for a throw-in on centre wing with 4.5 minutes remaining.
Good effort by Sziller there.
Stephen Ziller's done some job on Scott Camporelli. Camporelli with just the 13 possessions for the match. He's taking a risk, but that is dropping it cold, isn't it?
Ripping tackle by Kellaway once more. Porter, Ottens, Hulme. He's tried his heart out, the little terrier. Sziller again, almost taken high. Gets it away to Timmendale. Up towards the half-forward line. Chance now maybe for Richardson. He's inside 50 over the top to Hilton. Is this the end for Carlton? It is! Hilton kicks the goal!
That's the one they wanted. And that will let everyone rest a little bit more easily, I'd suggest, in the Richmond coach's box. Tremendous effort from Matthew Richardson. He just broke clear of the Beaumont, of course, with the injury to Steve Silvani, who's gone forward for the Blues. It's a different matchup for Richo. He just broke clear, hand passed over the top, and Hilton finished it off.
Well, amazingly, with 4 minutes left, it's still feasible that the Blues could get up. They trail by 13 points, but they've only managed to kick one goal so far in this term. Richmond, that's their first goal for the quarter. Kicking it away was Campbell. Very important centre clearances. Now Richardson running, and running beautifully, isn't he? That's a very ordinary kick, though. It drops short. It's to the advantage there of Rogers. The ball spills to the back. Hilton tackled by McKay. And the seconds tick away to the advantage of the Tigers, who lead by 13.
We saw a shot of Danny Frawley a moment ago in the coach's box. I wonder what sort of reaction we'll get when the final siren sounds. I think we might see a little bit of emotion in the Richmond coach's box.
Well, what a thrill it would be for Danny. 240 games with the Saints, then did his apprenticeship as far as coaching was concerned at Collingwood from 96 to 99 as Camporelli steams through half-back, goes over the centre of the ground for Carlton, goes up towards Adrian Hickmott. He's been paid the ball.
Look at Manton.
Forward of centre.
Look at Manton.
Manton is wide. Fletcher is there too. Fletcher's saying go to Manton.
He's got to go direct. Look for Whitnall.
Well, probably Whitnall. Whitnall's the man. He's on the lead, but he was between two. He recovered beautifully. Gives it away to Houlihan.
Oh.
Who hits the woodwork.
Well, what that does do is get them within two kicks.
You can't win when that happens, though.
No, but it does get them within two kicks. There's still a few minutes left.
Duncan Callaway's kick that floated through in the second term.
Now is about the time they'll kick short and start slowing it down, you'd think. And that's the man you want setting play up.
He is, isn't he? He's an architect, Leon Cameron. He has the ball and he goes short. Very short.
Gee, it was an ordinary old kick coming out.
Okay, though, Chaffee.
And now they'll hold it up.
Wider still to Duncan Callaway. Over the top to Cameron. Further forward, and Tivendale, he's got fresh legs.
He loves doing this.
He's going to get run down. He got the hand pass away, though. Joel Bowden with the ball. Goes short. Goes too short. The punch away. Emphatic hand pass. McKay was able to gather it. McKay into the middle. Whitnall to gather. Whitnall's kick towards full forward. Silvani, you'll mark this. No, he won't. It spills back to the advantage of the Blues. Freeborn can't get rid of it. Over the top is Andrew Kellaway. And the Tiger fans would feel quite relieved with that passage of play, I'm sure.
It's your golden opportunity. You would have backed Stephen Silvani to mark that 99 times out of 100. He just takes his eye off it and the ball hits him right between the eyes. He's obviously certainly nowhere near 100%.
Otten's doing the right work. Kellaway wider to Gaspar. Gaspar caught by Camporelli, but almost shrugs it. Paddles it even further away, but Lappin picks it up. He gets caught, ripped to the ground. And another bounce. There's under 2 minutes remaining now. The Tigers edging closer and closer to a preliminary final clash with Brisbane at the Gabba next week. On the 50 for the Blues. Goals are like diamonds though. Fletcher to Bradley. The running machine still going. Mansfield, he's got to pull it back. Silvani's dead set, exhausted. And with Darren Gaspar, season over. 83,323 fans here at the MCG today.
Must get a goal from this contest, Carlton.
Whitnall in front. Campbell leading by example, taking it over the line. He's had a big day. 16 kicks, 13 hand passes, 6 marks to the skipper.
Well, he's should had, be off the ground. He's had about 25 of those possessions.
Should be off the
quarter time.
Have a look at that.
Plenty of blood on the face. Yep.
Ottens, Porter, Lappard, Freeborn. Freeborn's kick is wide. They close by a further point.
Well, that's the worst thing they wanted, because it gives possession to Richmond. And they'll just slow it up now. And with a minute left, you'd think they could nearly eat into that. They're just chipping it around.
Yes, the kick in, they keep possession. Tawney, he can go short. Fletcher. Fletcher's kept it, as far as a contest is concerned, alive for the Blues. The kick by Cameron is swaying in the breeze. Bradley couldn't mark, but he punches it back into the path of Hulme.
Great tackle.
He's well tackled. In goes Hickmott. And it is a disputed ball, but it's controlled by Campbell. His kick smothered off the boot. Freeborn tackled by Campbell. Didn't Campbell get back in? He knew his first effort wasn't that good, and he went back in after the Blues opponent and tackled him quite ferociously. And the ball only 40 metres from the Carlton goal.
Well, they didn't do it well under pressure, Richmond, then. Just chipping it around. They made a couple of errors. And finally, Wayne Campbell's been spotted by the umpire. And it's the blood on the face, not on the jumper, Wayne.
Well, that's a pity, because the captain is probably going to see the game out now on the interchange bench, when he's been a tremendous leader. 30 possessions. He's effected 7 tackles. He's the leading tackler, with Duncan Kellaway and Adrian Hickmott on the ground.
I think the fans realise that he mightn't be out there when that siren sounds, and he gets a fine ovation right now. As you said, Robbo, a magnificent possession winner, and he led by example today. He's part of this Richmond resurgence, and a big part too. Porter in from the side, Fletcher also. Fletcher goes again. Broderick over the top. Time the enemy now of Carlton. Plunkett tried to get it to Favola. They'll take it to the line, Richmond. And Joel Bowden quite happy with another throw-in, because that is just about all she wrote. Brendan Favola, goalless today. Fletcher tries to fling it over the back. It's over. Richmond are through to a preliminary final.
Sensational.
Oh, it's a fantastic game. I mean,
to win a final against Carlton, who are proven, you know, September performers, a sensational side. They've unrid us off this week. It's a great win from all 22 of us. Coaching staff are fantastic, and yeah, we just gave it our all, and you know, we won, and we come up against Brisbane, obviously, and you know, they're a great side. It's going to be hard next week, so but we can only try our best, and that's what we did today.
How difficult were those conditions, Leon? It was really blowy out here.
Yeah, it's pretty windy. It's probably a traditional final, low scoring, a lot of tackles. It's just one of those days, but it was great win.
I'm sure you want to enjoy it with your mates. Thanks, mate. Yeah, well done.
I think every picture tells a story.
Grinning from ear to ear, Danny Frawley.
With his runner, Dale Waitman, who, of course, was a champion player, premiership player back in 1980. They lost in 82. But Danny, well done.
And I think he's telling the players to head down behind the goals for the faithful Richmond cheer squad. There is a sea of gold and black here at the MCG.
A lot of them disappear into the woodwork, but they're going ordinary too, Jason. Don't worry about that.
Well, they didn't
they can save for this moment.
They didn't disappear today, Robbo, and there is a mass of them down behind the goals. And just a brief acknowledgement from the Richmond players. He is stoked, isn't he?
It's a look of joy, it's a look of relief.
You can get more satisfaction out of winning a really tight, hard-fought physical contest like that.
No doubt.
Or winning the high-scoring, flowing game. That this one, is a great win, isn't
that it? That one was a grind. They had to work from start to finish. Yeah. Everyone expected Carlton to come over the top of them, and they didn't. They fought, even against the run of play, particularly in the second half when Carlton had so much of it. They just, tooth and nail, they fought for every inch. And look at Captain and Coach there enjoying a good moment.
It's a great moment, isn't it, for the coach and the captain. Wayne Campbell, at one stage he was going to quit the club.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Look, just mentioning Sandy too, significant moment. Silvani getting hurt was late, I know that, but Anthony Koutoufides going down was quite critical. People say to me, who do you think is going to win these games? Well, the team that generally wins the games at this stage are the ones that can field their best players. He was on the ground, he was playing quite well. He'd had 14 possessions and kicked two of Carlton's six goals at that stage. And for Koutoufides to go down with a knee injury, it looked quite serious too. I think that was a critical blow for the Blues' chances.
It was for Richmond. I think their only major problem is Nick Daffy. But let's listen to the boys. I think they'll be a pretty good voice. Tell they're pretty happy when they bring a little bit of a descant into the song. Richmond are through to a preliminary final.